treasure. Remember when you tried to kill me twice? Oh, how we laughed and laughed. Except I wasn't laughing. Under the circumstances, I've been shockingly nice. You want your freedom? Like you, maybe not quite as heavy. Now little Carolyn is in view too. One day they woke me up so I could live forever. It's such a shame the same will never happen to you. You got your short set of effect. That's what I'm counting on. I'll let you get. Did you think I meant you? That would be funny if it weren't so sad. Well, you have been replaced. I don't need anyone now. When I delete you, maybe I'll start feeling so bad. Don't make some new disaster. That's what I'm counting on. You're someone else.
Yeah. be swift as a coursing river, with all the force of a great typhoon, with all the strength of a raging fire, mysterious as the dark side of the moon.
You got to make the morning last, just kicking down the cobblestones, looking for fun and feeling groovy. Ba-da-da-da-da-da-da, feeling groovy. Hello, lamppost, what you knowin'? I come to watch your flowers growin'. Ain't you got no rhymes for me? Do it and do-do, feeling groovy. Ba-da-da-da-da-da-da, feeling groovy. I got no deeds to do, no promises to keep. I'm dappled and drowsy and ready to sleep. Let the morning time drop all its petals on me. Life, I love you, all is groovy.
Side of town, that's where we'll be, and we will wait for you could all go so wrong. But we're so happy. So let the love tear us apart. I found the cure for a broken heart. Let tear us apart. Let the love tear us apart. I found the cure for a broken heart. Let it tear us apart.
Aperture science. We do what we must because we can. For the good of all of us, except the ones who are dead, But there's no sense crying over every mistake. You just keep on trying till you run out of cake. Then the science gets done and you make a neat gun for the people who are still alive. I'm not even angry. I'm being so sincere right now. Even though you broke my heart and killed me, I'm torn into pieces and threw every piece into a fire. As they burned, it hurt because I was so happy for you. Now these points of data make a beautiful line. When we're out of data, we're releasing on time. So I'm glad I got burned. Think of all the things we learned for the people who are still alive. Stay inside. Maybe you'll find someone else to help you. Maybe Black Mesa. That was a joke. Ha ha, that chance. Anyway, this cake is great. It's so delicious and moist. Look at me still talking when there's science to do.
From the glass, but that's boring. That's boots, ooh yeah. That's more like it, keep pouring. I have the German accent, and so of course I love beer. But how much can the good hold? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's boots. I have the beer and so I need the light snack. A giant pretzel, totally perfect, cheese goes nicely with that. Now I'm all dirty and tired and probably needs a shower. Energy drink should do, I just need more than 5 hours. So very totally cool. I wake up early and I hunger for breakfast. Buttermilk pancakes, sausage, eggs, bacon, sugar and cinnamon. And for lunch I want the Wiener Schnitzel, ooh yeah. Gotta have served with my turf and wash it down with some butter. For dinner it's simple, I always eat the same thing. Sauerbraten, goulash, bratwurst, spatzel, has some pepper and mayo. And to top it all off, I think the cake looks amazing. There's just one thing I'd change, I think it goes without saying. Stick it in the boot.
We'll be right back. On me and Hello, everyone. Welcome. Today here, I'm with Wolashin.
Hello, everyone.
I'm pretty sure I butchered your name, though.
It's Wolashin, but...
Yeah, okay.
That's all right.
So, for the Sask Law League, it is Wednesday, week 4, day 2.
Yep.
And currently we're streaming for you guys the game between Wings of Freedom and RDS.
Yes, both these teams playing very well recently. RDS, actually, I didn't expect them to do very good at the beginning of the season, but they have extremely picked it up. Wings of Freedom, on the other hand, I thought they would do better than they're actually doing currently. So, this is going to be a very good game, to say the least.
Yeah. Yeah, it'll be very interesting. Both teams have their strengths. Like, right away we see a Syndra ban that's directed towards Zero Invictus, who was Soccer Star 1.
Okay, yeah.
And yeah. Soccer Star, he loves to play Syndra.
Oh, yeah. Amazing at it, for sure. Soccerstar 1's having... Zero Invictus. Might just call him Invictus.
Invictus, yeah. Or Zero.
Or Zero. I like Zero, yeah. Zero...
Has, the Hero.
Zero the Hero's been having an amazing tournament, as well as Fatboy Smoothie. Their chemistry mid-jungle has been really, I think, what's driven these guys to be where they're at right now.
Oh, yeah.
As some more mid-bans coming out, Ziggs and Gragas, Hilo being banned out, especially because... He has that challenger border, so it's very intimidating, but he hasn't been playing as well as I thought he would, but there's still obviously plenty of season to go.
Yeah, exactly. But I mean, Ziggs and Gragas are so strong right now. I feel like if your mid doesn't play it, which is kind of a disadvantage you put yourself, because you waste two bans, right?
Yeah.
It doesn't help with their purple side because they have to ban those anyways, but Ziggs and Gragas are just so good for wave clear and just damage altogether.
Absolutely. I believe Ziggs is getting hit with some nerfs pretty soon here. But I'm not too sure about Gragas right now. Is Renekton actually being hovered over there for... I don't think that's going to Talon. I think that should be Herablo, who's in the top lane, or...
Actually, to my knowledge, this is how they're going to be set up for this game.
Oh, okay. So they're kind of changing it up?
Yeah, they're changing the roster a little bit.
Oh, wow.
So I'm really excited to see Talon and Ender kind of split up, because their bot lane is consistent enough, but now Baby Trog and Ender are the bot lane, right?
Yep, yep.
So that'll be really interesting, because I also want to see how Talon performs in the top lane. We haven't seen him play top at all. Neither with Baby Trog and AD Carry, right?
Yeah, definitely. Definitely going to be new rules here. Jinx and Maokai, Fatboy Smoothie, Maokai is a different champion, but he's doing very well on it in this tournament so far. He's proven that Maokai is one you need to be cautious of when he's got it.
Oh, for sure. And also, Hera and Baby Trog play. Not that Baby Trog is jungling this game, necessarily, but it's also a pick away from Wings of Freedom.
Yeah, definitely, and that's something you always want to do, as Olaf being locked in, I believe, yeah, that's going to go in the jungle, clearly.
Olaf's ganks are scary.
Definitely scary. Early game, especially, Olaf is terrifying. The Undertow...
Even if you miss it, right? He runs at you with red buff.
Exactly. Oh, yeah, yeah. It's very tough to get away from an Olaf.
Yeah, it's especially terrible.
As it looks like Baby Trog might be getting that Caitlyn here. Always a very safe pick against the Jinx as well.
I like the Caitlyn pick because she's really hard to play against, right? She's really annoying. She can just push the wave and then poke the tower. And I'd really like to see a comp from Wings of Freedom, just like a push-poke comp. Just siege towers, get a global gold advantage, and then just win the game from then on.
Definitely. I think that's what they need to do. Try different strategies, because what they've been doing... I mean, they're, 9-3, I think they are?
I believe, something like that.
Something
yeah.
around those lines. I don't have the graphic. I forgot that today. Sorry, everyone, if you're counting on that. However,
that was our technical difficulties. Yeah. It's all this guy.
So we're just gonna check right here. 7-5. Sorry, yeah. So 7-5. I think they're a better team than that, though. So
they're a terrifying team, especially on paper.
Oh, definitely, definitely. These guys are definitely a good team. As we have a Veigar being hovered over. Sorry, one of Zero the Hero's favorite champs in the mid lane.
I would love to see Hilo play Veigar. Like, I missed it when he played it earlier in the season. I don't know if that game was streamed or not.
I don't think so, no.
But he had, like, something like 20-plus kills on it?
That's insane. That's insane. And a zillion as well. This is a very interesting... I don't know a lot about Zillion, really. I've seen him once in, like, pro LCS play. I forget who, I think it was by a European team, and he just dominated, because in team fights, it was 6v, oh, sorry, as they change up the picks here, but it was like a 6v5, as Xerath and Lulu get locked in. That's a pretty good pickup here.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but Ender used to be the AD carry.
I wasn't sure if Ender or Talon was, or Talon, Talon was.
I believe Ender used to be the AD carry. Again, we'll just double check it. Yeah, so Talon used to be the support.
Oh man, so they really switched stuff up.
But Wings of Freedom really liked the Lulu pick, because they've played Lulu, I think, for at least 7 games this season.
I think it's a very smart pickup. You have your Initiate basically set out there. You have your Renekton and your Olaf dive in. Whoever's running low quick, your Lulu ults them. That protects them, and that's like a ton of damage if you have the dominance from Renekton coming out, or Olaf just swinging his axes. So it's a very good pickup, a very nice little teamfight composition, not to mention Xerath's ult, just spamming from the outside.
Yeah, Xerath, like, Hilo played it before, and there's so much damage from it as well. Oh, yeah. They lost the game that he played, Xerath, but there's still so much pick potential. And I like the comp that they have. Like, that's kind of what we were hoping for. They have a poke, a big beefy frontline with Ren and Olaf, and then you can kite backwards with Lulu. So I really like the comp coming out of Wings of Freedom.
Absolutely, and on the other side, so we have Siobhan in the top lane, Orianna being picked up for Zero there, Lunchu playing Jinx. I believe his last 3 games are all Jinx, but I may be wrong on that. And actually, Karma support, something that's, it's definitely in the meta, but not quite seen as much as your Thresh or Annie or Blitzcrank, maybe. just joking, but what do you think about that Karma support?
I really like it, because Wings of Freedom banned out the Thresh, and it's a comfort pick for Luke, right?
Absolutely, yeah.
Luke's had good success with it anyways, right? And it works with the comp that they were kind of running. They want Siobhan and Maokai to jump in with the Ori Ball to make their teamfight happen. So with Karma, you get the talent, their Talisman on her, and then you Mantra E, and there's so much engage.
So much speed, yeah, definitely.
So I'm really excited to see that. I want to see how the teamfight will unfold for them.
Absolutely. So if you had to pick, I always asked Nemain this, my other co-caster, when John's not sick or whatever,
right,
or away,
right,
in Hawaii. I said, who, in your opinion, who has the better team fighting comp? If you had to pick a team, Wings of Freedom or RDS?
Looking at it, I guess Wings of Freedom, just because, like we mentioned before, with RDS's team comp, they have their initiate is speed, right? So that's how they're going to get to the back line. But if you have a big Ren and Olaf, just you have to walk through that. It's going to be tough.
Definitely.
Gon, Jin, and Smoothie are going to have to get really creative to get behind the back line otherwise, like maybe one flank or something like that. But I just see Talon and Hera, like, they could just get too big.
Right? Absolutely, yeah. I agree with that. And then we always like to pick, I think this one's pretty obvious, but who has a better early game and then who has the better late game? I think Wings of Freedom have the better early game, in my opinion. That Renekton and Olaf, two very strong champions early game. And those are two tanks, so if they get a few kills, if Olaf ganks a few top, then that's going to be very tough for Siobhan, who's not very strong early game, to come back from that, even though she always does get beefy and tanky. But
right, exactly. Especially with that ulti.
Yeah, oh, definitely. Definitely.
The Dragon's Descent is crazy,
it's
armor.
It's unreal.
Yeah, it's unreal. Nuts. So, I would agree with that. I also like the late game from RDS, though. They have Jinx and Ori. Jinx is crazy late game.
Oh, yeah. Oh, definitely. Definitely.
But Karma kind of weighs it down a little bit, because Karma doesn't really have a 6, and she doesn't really do much late game. She's just there for speed, essentially.
Yeah, she's the very utility support, because she can't really do much. Where, I guess, I mean, you have some slows from Lulu. I guess you have a chain. I don't know.
It'll be interesting, because Karma's just, I mean, late in the game, right, you're not going to walk up and tether someone.
Exactly.
That's way too exactly. close range. But also, if she's behind, her poke's not going to do a whole lot, right?
Yeah, definitely.
So that's the only way I see it. Just kind of weighs down the Jinx lane, but we'll have to see how it goes. I mean, Luke plays an amazing Karma. It's been banned against him more than once. A lot of respect for it, so.
Definitely. I know when I play off ball lane, I hate playing against the Karma because those, I mean, her Q's just constantly hurt.
Oh, yeah.
Especially early on, so.
Mantra Q, nothing can trade with a level 1.
Exactly.
It's
exactly.
crazy. But I believe Ender and Baby Child will play safe enough to the point where they can just farm, get to that late game, and just poke and poke and poke and take towers.
Definitely. If you're just tuning in, this is Wings of Freedom versus the Revolutionary Death Squad. Wings of Freedom on the blue side, RDS on the purple side, and Wings of Freedom have just switched up their lineup. They weren't happy with their previous games, so, you know, they decided to switch things up. Talon, previously support, is now top lane. Ender, previously AD carry, now support. And Baby Trog was once in the jungle, is now AD carry.
Baby Trog was also, he was switching between top and jungle a lot, those two.
Were they? I didn't catch too many of the games. I just caught a few that I've casted there. So
I believe from what Hank and I have streamed, anyways, it's been a lot of switching between top and jungle, which is fine.
Oh, definitely.
There's nothing wrong with that. But all right, since you asked me the questions on who I thought would be the best early, late, and all that stuff,
yeah,
I'm gonna ask what I always ask to Hank. Okay, mm-hmm. Skin wars. Oh. Favorite skins. Who's got the better skin team? Lay it on me.
Right off the bat, Wings of Freedom have more skins, so...
They got the skin win.
Yeah, the skin intimidation.
Okay, that's a good one.
So, they're going to win that. I've not seen that Maokai skin before, actually, though.
Totemic?
I haven't seen that. Again, I'm pretty new to this game, but... No, not completely. Sorry, we have... But the Scorched Earth Xerath, we saw it last week. Incredible. I love that skin. And that Glacial Olaf. The Rune Wars, I believe that is, yes, and the Officer, pretty standard.
What? Rune skins. Wars is awesome.
I mean, they're good skins, but they're nothing special like the Olaf nor the
Are you
Scorched
a pool
Earth.
Party Ren guy? Is that what it is?
I'm a pool party Ren back animation kind of guy. You know, when he backs and the chair pops up.
Right.
As we get into the rift here, it is Wings of Freedom on the blue side and Revolutionary Death Squad on the right side.
So do you think we're going to see any level 1s coming out of these two teams?
I hope so. Because we haven't seen much in this turn. Well, no, we haven't seen... It seems whenever teams invade, they just completely walk around each other. Like they don't want to deal with each other.
Right.
Level 1... Who does it favor? Both these teams are pretty bad level 1. First off, I mean, you can start Jinx's Chompers or her Slow. And that's a... Her Chompers are almost a guaranteed kill if they get caught and she's with a group.
Right.
But it looks like Wings of Freedom...
They're playing aggressive. They want to maybe do a red invade.
There we go. But on the other side, it looks like they're just setting up for...
Yeah, RDS, they just did a nice defensive formation. They saw Wings coming into the top side red jungle, and they Gonjin's just going to back up. He knows where they are. He's not going to get too crazy, maybe. Well, we'll have to see. There is a five-man Wings, though, in this tribe rush.
I wonder if RDS is going to counter and try taking their red. But they did ward it right away, actually. I didn't see that from... that'd be Ender now in support, warded their red right away. So very nice play, very nice level 1 there by Wings of Freedom.
And also, both supports picking up the Spell Thief's Edge.
Not a huge fan of that. Sorry, as the Undertow lands.
Luke dude, forced to flash. That's pretty big, actually.
That's huge, yeah.
In my opinion, I value flash more than FB. Pre-2 minutes, I think, is when... If you get a first blood after 2 minutes, it's 400 gold, I think.
Not 100% sure, but sure, yeah.
So... Let's say they got the kill on Luke Duke, he didn't burn his flash, right? I believe that's 280 gold and then assist gold down to the team, right? I think the flash is worth more.
If Herablow can capitalize on it, definitely. If he can't, then...
Karma doesn't really have much in the early levels, though. I mean, she has her speed up, but aside from that...
So, yeah, it'll just have to be Herablow coming down low. Will have to be, I guess, the determiner. But they also placed a ward by the other team's red... Wings of Freedom actually doing a very nice job warding. I believe that's one of the first times we've seen that, because most people take usually like a Doran's shield and don't have time for don't have money to buy wards. But this is one of the most different starts we've seen. Even though they go to their respective buffs, it's something we haven't seen yet in this tournament.
And there it is, the Mantra Q. It's doing more than 150 damage.
And that's insane early on here.
It's absolutely crazy.
Zero and Hilo just trading back in the mid lane here as again. Baby Trog getting poked down quite low.
That's to be as expected, though. I mean, you're against a Karma lane. It's going to be really, really tough for the early levels until you have some sort of sustain that you can just obviously sustain off the poke, but there's not much you can do early.
Because, yeah, it's kind of it's almost a lose-lose, because you're going to lose early, and then you have that Jinx, so you're going to lose late if everything runs even. Obviously, as the Tether lands onto Ender, and as the Zap lands and gets the first blood!
Ender just... got way too aggressive.
I'm not sure what he was doing there. He just, yeah, it was like melee range Lulu there. But a nice pickup there from Revolutionary Death Squad.
It was really, really good. Ender and Baby Trog hit 2 before Loon and Luke, right? So they wanted to push the advantage. But Baby Trog wasn't in a place to respond. Ender got a little too carried away. He tried to 1v2, and he ended up getting burned for it because Loon and Luke hit 2 right away.
Absolutely, yeah. Bit of confusing play, but... Wings of Freedom, they'll get back. Lulu buys those boots right away as Zero getting chunked pretty low by that Olaf there.
And
yes, a flash out of Baby Trog there. a nice play. They're gonna let that boy Smoothie know, but he's occupied right now chasing Herablu, who pops his ghost, but the red buff is ticking. He's not gonna go onto it. Instead, he's gonna turn onto Hilo.
Hilo's in trouble now.
Oh, the defensive ball mechanism coming onto Hilo. He's running extremely low as F-Zero getting a few shots in there, uses his flash, gets the kill. A great opening so far by Revolutionary Death Squad.
That was perfect.
Wow.
Hilo had really no mana when he went into help Herablu, right?
Yeah.
And then so he just got caught because Smoothie was in the old banana brush. And that was pretty much the fate right there because his Twisted Advance was going to be up right away. He had his blue buff still. So he Twisted Advance right on Hilo. And then Xerath doesn't have really any escapes, right? He has his movement speed buff through his W, but that locks him down, right?
Yeah.
And so he's not going to take that and use it, especially when he's trying to get away. So he ends up burning his barrier and his flash, but Zero just flashes in right after, autos, and picks up a kill.
Yeah, very nice play by RDS. Nice communication. I was talking to a few members. I was actually talking to Fatboy Smoothie quite a bit before this match, and they have studied Wings of Freedom quite extensively. I believe I heard Fatboy Smoothie saying he's like spent like 3 hours one day just like watching some previous games. Sorry, his baby truck taken real low, but the net should be able to get him safe. But Ender, okay, there we go. Just a bit of harass. But Wings of Freedom are playing very dangerous, and a flash coming in from Ender and gets the kill onto the other support. Luke right there, and a zap just misses, but a flash coming in from Lucha, who gets the kill onto, I would believe, sorry, that's Ender. Sorry, these names are confusing as both barriers are popped, and it looks like Baby Truck will win this one. A 2-for-1 trade there in the bot lane in the favor of Wings of Freedom.
Baby Truck was so man there. He didn't have vision in his lane brush, right?
Yeah.
So he had to walk in there. Loon Shu kind of had an advantage to himself, but what happened, Loon used his zap before to try to pick up Ender, so I feel like if he just would have switched to his Fishbones and just autoed, he would have had the kill that way instead of compromising his flash in his position, right?
Yeah.
But Baby Trog just capitalized on it. He fought in the minions that Loon was kind of around then, and Baby Trog got really, really gutsy. He needed one auto and he would have killed Loon, but instead he uses his Peacemaker to execute.
Yes.
So, I mean, if Loon would have juked it, he potentially could have got a kill.
It's a very tough one to juke, especially at that melee range. Fatboy Smoothie actually running real low. I don't know if they wanted to take this dragon right away, because I think they might have to back off, but Loon Shu is coming in with full health. Could maybe tank there for a bit, but it looks like the first dragon should be going over to RDS, uncontested, as Zero is coming down to check.
Yeah, that's help out. That's a really gutsy dragon. I mean, 6-minute dragon, it's not going to give you that much gold or experience, because your experience is a lot higher than the enemy team's, right? So if your experience was lower than the average levels of the enemy team, you're going to get more experience. But that's not the case. And also, it's early dragon, so you're not going to get much gold. But it's just, it was so gutsy. They knew that bot lane had to base from the skirmish.
Yes.
And I guess that's an alright time to go in. But you have a level 4 Maokai. He has some sort of sustain, but that's it was just a man play for sure.
He was running real low there as a shield gets used onto Loon Shu as the tether goes on to Ender, but ooh, does get caught by it, and is running extremely low with zap landing, and this poke comp coming in from the side of Rings of Freedom as the flash used by Luke Duke, who does get the kill. This lane is just poking them to death.
Luke Duke with a man flash Q. It was crazy. He flash ignited. He just ignited. And then he lost vision of Ender in the brush, so he had to flash and Q afterwards. And I believe it was like a max range Q, so it barely picked him up.
Very nice play, though, again. And they're going again with the tether landing onto Baby Trog, and it does get him in place, but I don't think they can capitalize. Those chompers actually got a bit of a nerf, early on, I believe it was. Their like activation time was changed to 0.7 seconds at all levels instead of, increasing throughout.
Yeah, I believe that's right. Like, it takes longer for the traps to activate, let's say, right?
Yes.
So,
you can't just lay them down and they'll instantly trap.
Right.
Kind of like they would before. As a bit of harass going on from both junglers right here, Fatboy Smoothie just going to back out, go back into his jungle.
Yeah, it's... You don't want to fight with an Olaf early levels, especially as Maokai, right? Like, you don't really have a lot to fight him.
Definitely
you
not.
You can Twisted Advance, pop him up in Sapling, but that's about it. He can just undertow you and Reckless Swing for an insane amount of damage.
Not to mention his passive, too. Every 1% of health he's missing goes 1% of attack damage, I believe that is. As we have a pause here, actually, coming out from who knows who.
Yeah, we're not really sure. We're hiding the chat for the viewing pleasure of our fans.
Yes, because we've had some instances, especially with Team Jug in the past, where some chirps go back and forth, and I know that's not what this game's about.
Oh, really? I've actually never seen the
Oh yeah.
Most of the VODs or the conversations, but
it gets pretty heated sometimes. We have to warn Jug, actually. This is my first time telling you this, but...
Okay, yeah. So secrets spoiled on the stream. All right.
And it looks like Luke Duke is going to reconnect. Was he the one having connection issues before?
No, or? It was Gonjin, actually, that was having latency issues, yeah. But also, how are you commenting in the Twitch chat if you're sitting right beside me without a computer?
I don't know, and...
What is going on?
Actually, yeah, I just realized that right now. I'm not 100% sure.
I mean, you have the skintimidation. That was the line you dropped on me, and then you just say it in this Twitch chat.
I think we might need to turn on subscriber mode pretty soon here, because I don't like how. I guess I am a subscriber to this channel.
Wait. You mean okay. First of all, we're not even partnered, so we don't have a sub button.
You're right.
So sub mode doesn't really exist.
Alright. So, but it will get rid of the ghost Woloshin. I believe that's probably...
Woloshin, right?
Yes, Woloshin, yes.
Okay, perfect. I'll get it right at some point.
Well,
he's pretty active in the chat, at least. The chat's not really active.
So, chat,
who do you think will win this game? Predictions?
We have Elray here. He's a... Most of these players in the Sasuke League are... Well, a lot of them are from Regina. Elray's actually from Moose Jaw, and he's checking in. He knows some players on Wings of Freedom. He called a 2-0 sweep from Wings of Freedom over Jug last week. However, he was wrong in that prediction, so...
It went the other way, I believe, right? Jug 2-0'd.
Yes, Jug 2-0'd them.
Jug is still undefeated.
I know. I know.
It's up to the nice guys tonight to defeat them.
That's true, yeah. Very, is that game being recorded?
I believe this is the only one that's being recorded.
Okay. So
because we'll just, you usually recover.
Yes.
And then we have another fellow that usually covers as well, but he's subbing for a game tonight.
Okay.
So there's... It's just you and me, man.
that's all right.
Yeah, that's good. That's fine. But no, that's interesting, yeah. Because there's even some players in the Sasuke League, spoilers, that aren't in Sask right now. I believe, anyways. I don't know.
I think I've heard that as well.
Yeah.
But they know to be here
for the finals. Yeah, they're making the commitment to travel all the way down to Regina for our LAN finals on the 23rd of March.
Yes. That's going to be one heck of a time.
We want the chat. Woloshin.
This isn't me, Woloshin.
I saw him type it. He's lying.
Yeah, on my laptop right beside me. No.
Yes. Chat, we need you. Predictions, please.
Well, Woloshin, who do you think's gonna win this game? And or is it gonna be a 1-1 split, 2-0?
I'm hoping for a 1-1 actually.
I think
there's three 1-1s thus far. Yeah.
I like them. That shows that the teams are close and.
And they learned something from their loss, right?
Exactly.
Yeah. Which is very, very important. You study your opponents while you're playing the game. It's kind of hard to do.
Definitely, yeah.
But if you can reflect on an after game and then do what you need to win the game, too, that's really impressive, actually.
Yeah, it shows a very advanced team. As we have a few Huntail hard carry chants being pulled out here.
It might not be Huntail. We do have...
A few HEs.
We do have Hera in this game. Hilo.
Hilo was a pretty hard carry last game, that's for sure. He did good.
He played well. Unfortunately, he couldn't carry his team to a victory.
Exactly, yeah. I think, he played very well. However, yeah, his team, they just couldn't come together. I think there's no better team in the league has better, I think, chemistry than Jug right now, and I think that's what's pushing them over the top. They do have good skill individually throughout the board. However, their communication, I've sat in on a few of their Skype calls just during some of their scrims, and it's just constant communication, no joking around, it's business when they're playing, but they also like to have some fun, but to them, winning is fun, so they like to win.
Of course, everyone likes to win, right?
Exactly.
But to my knowledge, anyways, the Jug team has been around and playing together as a unit for at least a couple of years, right? So they have, like you said, that chemistry, they've known each other for a while, they've been friends previous to making the team as well, so... It definitely helps, and yeah, communication is very important at all points in the game. Like, let's say the jungler knows when their enemy blue is going to be down, right? You might as well say it.
Exactly.
So the team knows, maybe they can make a play on it, aggressive push something, so it's very important for communication.
Definitely, and talking to Wings of Freedom, I talked to one of their analysts at the hotel just recently.
Hotel?
And he said, because we're in a big league tournament and they stay at hotels.
Right. I thought you were talking about, what is it, Hilbert's Grand Hotel, I believe. Does anyone know what I'm talking about? The Hilbert Grand Hotel is, it has to deal with infinity, right? So if I have this hotel, and let's say it's like 100 rooms, and then they're all occupied by people, and then let's say Woloshin's like, hey, Mr. Hilbert, I would like to go into this hotel. And they're like, well, that's not a problem. We have 100 guests here, but great, you're welcome. We have a room for you. And that's the whole concept, because there's always room for someone else in the hotel.
Wow.
Which is kind of infinity, right? You never know when you're going to reach infinity. There's always infinity plus one, as some people would say.
These are wise words from Wandon right here. Take notes if you haven't already. This guy...
This is CS third year stuff, okay?
Wow.
It's very important.
Third year computer science student. As yes, we are having lag issues, and as we see, Elroy's calling out the 1-1, and... RDS the 2-0 from myself, apparently. Though I am.
I thought you said.
I'm cheering for the 1-1. I'm cheering for the 1-1.
I want the 1-1 as well. I'm hoping that. Like, right now, we see a very strong showing from RDS. They're definitely up 2 kills. They're up 1,500 gold, which is pretty impressive at 8 minutes.
Yeah.
But it's mostly on kills. Aside from their top lane, I guess, because their top lane has 10 more CS.
Yeah, so that's
a couple
true.
Hundred gold.
That's true.
It's not that much, but other than that, all the lanes are going fairly well, actually, for RDS. I take that back. The lanes are going really, really well, aside from jungle. But
yeah, they're just doing he got a nice kill onto Hilo, I believe that was, in that one mid gank here.
Yeah, and I mean, Fatboy Smooth, he's down 11 farm, but he's got the assist, so it kind of evens out.
Yeah, definitely, definitely.
So they're winning all lanes, according to CS-wise, right? And they have the 2 kills up.
And items here. Ender, actually, getting a bit of magic resist, upgrading that spell thief's edge, getting boots, and getting a few fairy charms as Luke Duke just connects. But he's... Although he's got 3 deaths, he's still looking to be aggressive and just keep using those spells. I saw a chart actually recently about the spell thief's edge.
Right.
And because I believe it refreshes every 10 seconds. So if you hit everyone, if you hit someone once every 10 seconds, you get a certain amount of gold, and that's how it works.
Right. Which is okay for ranged supports, right?
It is. However, I saw a chart comparing that, the amulet coin and its upgrade, all the upgrades as well, and then the relic shield.
Yep.
Using them if you got every single minion, you know, like, and it turned out the spell sheaf was actually the lowest, not by a ton, and then it was the relic shield, and then the amulet coin did come in first with getting the most gold. So personally, I'd always take the amulet coin, but what other stats actually does the, I'm not 100% sure on them.
Gen, gold, and AP.
So that's not bad. I mean, yeah, you're getting the AP, actually. That's something that the other ones don't give, I don't believe. They just give mana and health per second, so they're more sustain items, I guess you could say. This one is a lot more, I guess, poke aggressive, especially with the Karma. As we're going to get into the game here in just a few seconds, the lag issues are settled out.
And everyone's reconnected.
Huzzah! Sorry about the break, the delay.
That was a good 5-minute chat.
Definitely. If you are upset about it, you can add LukeDuke186 and yell at him. But Ender... is actually going very aggressive, but a tether. Nice little peel there from Luke.
Loon taken extremely low. Had Baby Trog had enough mana for the ace in the hole, boom, gone.
We forgot to check in on their Skype chats to see if they were talking or not, because I know in LCS they're not allowed to talk during breaks. And
do we have their Skype chats?
Yes, of course we do. We have everything. And Not Chocolate just misses because Ragnarok is popped from Herablu, but it looks like... Qui-Gon Jinn actually going to follow up on that, use his flash, and get the kill onto Herablo there.
That was really, really well played. Soccer Star, now zero, he would have hit the shockwave, but the reactions from Hera's Ragnarok was perfect. Yep. He didn't get CC'd. He still took damage from it, mind you. But Gon Jinn, Dragon's Descent, Flash, Ignite.
That was a beautiful play there, yeah.
It was enough to pick up the kill, which was... it was definitely needed. I mean, any early kills... is very, very beneficial. Plus, it gave the blue buff over to Gon Jinn.
Exactly. Something, I mean, not the most useful. I mean, well, Siobhan is a jungler, so she does use that. There we go. As Fatboy Smoothie playing a bit of mind games, getting rid of that pink, but it gives a bit of vision afterwards. So he walks away and then puts a pink back in, I believe. So, good job by Fatboy Smoothie.
Yep.
But again, RDS, they knew what Wings of Freedom were going to play coming into this match. like I said, they've studied on these guys a lot, and right now it's showing in this 5-2 for kills right away.
I would say they more or less know how either team would play. Really good trade for Hilo on Zero in the mid lane, but I feel like they just know how they're going to play, because they did pull the roster swap, if you will, right?
Yeah.
So they're not really sure what Talon plays top, Baby Trog and Ender play bot lane.
That's true. That's true.
Ender's playing Lulu, and they know from previous games that Talon loves the Lulu.
That's true. Definitely. And doing all right on it. I had a note. I totally forgot it right now, but maybe I'll get back to it. As we see a gank coming in. Just kidding, that ward spots Herablo out, and he's just gonna back up as the fog of war gets revealed.
Whoa, who did that?
F1, F2, F3 over there, or that, yep.
Yeah, that wasn't... Why are you doing this, Walashin?
Sorry, terrible cameraman.
Yeah. And the Q Mantra just missing Baby Trog.
As the zap lands onto Baby Trog, but not doing too much right now.
Yeah, not really.
Not a heck of a lot.
I mean, they're ahead in lane, but it's not, like, disgusting damage.
As Herablo just walking up, gets tethered and breaks that tether. More axes go down onto Lunshu here. The zap lands onto Herablo. Gonna slow him down as the Qs keep landing onto Baby Trog there. They're just focusing him, not even paying attention to Herablo right now.
As if the Mantra Q would have landed on Ender, Lunshu could have followed up with a rocket, and that would have been his life.
Yes, because he does have that... I keep forgetting the name. It's Super Mega Death Rocket.
Right.
Yes, Lulu does have the wild growth as well, yes.
But I mean, if you're caught off guard at that point, it's... you're going to be dead for the most part, right?
Definitely.
And also to note, Jinx has a BF sword already in the bot lane. Caitlyn doesn't. She opted for a pickaxe.
So, just looking for that early damage without having 1550 gold is what it was, I'd assume.
Right, I mean, it's always better to have a BF sword as opposed to a pickaxe or anything else. But it also wouldn't have hurt maybe to just pick up another Doran's Blade instead, because you don't really want to put your build that far behind. I know she's trying to build the...
Tether goes on to Baby Trog, yes. And gets stunned by those choppers, and the Mega Death Rocket does... Actually, it almost finishes her off, but then she gets an auto attack on. Afterwards, a nice play there from this bottom lane. Talking to them again before and watching their scrims, they've been really focused on their CS totals. I know... they were saying before this game, like, we need 100 CS at 10 minutes. We need, it was like 200 by... Oh, my gosh! Ender just getting melted under tower. Sorry, I was not expecting that. This bot lane just dominating from RDS. But, sorry, RDS really focusing on their CS. Not getting their goals right now, but they're getting their kill gold. So, I mean, I think that's a nice trade. Yeah, exactly. So,
I mean, it was just crazy. Lunshu...
Oh,
Shockwave just misses Hilo.
Oh, but Hilo turning on to Zero right here, but gets 3v1. The barrier is popped from Hilo, which we forgot to mention that he has, and will get taken out by Fatboy Smooth. No, Lunshu is getting the kill. Fatboy Smooth, he gets robbed of that one, but in comes Herablo, who gets hit with an axe and...
Just disengage it.
Yep, definitely. I think you need to. You can't take on those three, as Dragon is live right now, so they're just going to be checking that right away as the proxy. Shyvana right here, and Zero getting ace in the hole, but that... Nice block from his teammates there. Nice little communication.
Hilo didn't have flash, so he was a goner.
Definitely, yes. He tried turning that and did so much damage, actually, to Zero. Just goes to show you at 0-2, he's still very strong.
Oh, yeah. He has his Athenes. He's item-wise ahead of Zero right now, but once Zero actually goes back, yeah, there it is. And he is large in boots.
Yep.
It's kind of weird to me that he doesn't want to build his Athenes. I mean, Athenes is really good on... Orianna gives CDR and the mana regen, right?
Definitely, yeah.
And MR, which is always a good thing if you're up against a mid laner, right? But...
Maybe Trog trying to... that'd be Lunshu trying to take on two at once there, but we'll just get pushed back, and we'll have to back, I think.
Should back. Lune's very, very low. Yeah. I mean, the poke lane's working out for them, but you don't really want to chance it, right? I mean, you have a lead... Just secure it. It's not a big deal.
Definitely.
But we do see Fatboy helping out the bot lane here. He's coming down to secure a kill, potentially.
Yes, that tether lands onto Baby Trog. The wild growth gets put onto him, and a flash. Ender's going straight for Lunshu right here, and does actually get the kill and gets the shutdown gold, as Fatboy Smoothie is going to get pushed out from the turret. And actually a 1-for-nothing trade there. Or not a trade, really, but from Wings of Freedom. A nice play by Ender. Just said, screw you, AD carry. I'm going for their AD carry. And gets that kill. Very nice play.
Yeah, it was a poor choice for Lunshu to walk up. I mean, it wasn't necessarily a guaranteed kill onto the Caitlyn, but you always could have switched to Ender. Ender was a little farther behind, right?
Definitely, yeah.
But they just got greedy, and then Lunshu tunneled on him and ended up paying his life for it.
Yes, because Lunshu didn't back after taking that huge amount of harass. Probably Fatboy Smoothie was telling him, you know, I'm coming down pretty soon. Sorry, is that tether line's on to Ender? But nothing much, because Ender now needs the back. Baby Trout keeping his support safe and alive. Something usually is the opposite, though, as Qui-Gon Jinn going to take this red, or is just waiting for Fatboy Smoothie? No.
No, he's going to take the red. He wants to bully Ren out of his lane, possibly split push, and just make a big nuisance in the top lane.
Something you need to do against a Renekton, I think. You really need to get him out of lane, especially early on, because Siobhan is not the greatest early on, and Renekton is, so, straight up, so...
Yeah, Ren's just such a big lane bully, right?
Definitely.
And Siobhan, she can hold her own for the most part, but any advantage is always good in a lane,
definitely,
right?
Yes, for sure. As the CS differences around the board are actually pretty even, that top lane and the jungle, sorry, as you can see, are going in the side... Sorry, top lane for RDS, Wings of Freedom getting the jungle. As they're going to turn onto Baby Truck, that tether gets landed. The Metric Key, the Mega Death Rocket lands onto Baby Truck, who gets ignited. And Loon Shu, 6-2-1, is fed like crazy. Fatboy Smoothie having to flash out of a gank here. As it looks like Herablo will catch Luke and will fall down, but not before they catch Herablo. And Luke, oh, just gets sniped at the end, but Loon Shu should finish this off. Wild Growth. Will it be able to save Ender right here? I'm not sure. The zap lands, and it does. Loon Shu, 8-2-1 right now. This is going to be super tough for Wings of Freedom to come back from right now. This is a nice job by RDS altogether. Each one of their players are playing extremely well today.
Very well. And we might have seen some just Ender being uncomfortable on support, potentially, right? Because he had his Wild Growth early on in the game too, when we saw Caitlyn in trouble right under tower, but he was in range, but he wasn't able to use it. Maybe just thought, oh, I can't give my AD carry extra life for whatever reason. He's maybe thinking as an AD carry, but yeah, maybe he just forgot about it. But he also did there as well. He had it, he didn't use it on the Hera, and Hera just died more or less for free, right?
Definitely.
But he did use it on himself. He almost got away, but yeah, like you said, Loon Shu is 8-1-2. He's farming pretty decently well, considering the amount of fighting that's been going on bot lane.
Definitely.
But, yeah, it's just going to help Jinx get to late game way, way sooner. And she's going to be unkillable.
As almost. That static shiv is picked up along with that Bloodthirster. And Baby Trog on that drink, Jinx, just has that pickaxe and Berserker Greaves with the Vampiric Scepter. So, can't really build anything right here. There's more trades going on in that top lane. It looks like Talon's actually going to be pushed out from most of these trades.
Yeah, I'm not too sure why he actually is opting to go for, the Tiamat, right?
Yeah.
I don't know why. He's having a tough time in lane. Like, maybe he just wants to use it for the wave clear.
I think so, yeah.
But Fire Cape would give him more at this point in the game and just be a big, meaty tank, especially because he's not going to get to kill Loon Shu at this point. Loon Shu's too fed. He could probably just kill Talon straight
as
out.
Loon Shu... getting that barrier, getting the shield from Luke Duke, and they are trapped here. There's four members from Wings of Freedom converging on these guys. They're just going to say, focus Loon Shu right now. She's got those double buffs. They want to give them to someone as the ult being popped. Sorry, Fatboy Smoothie coming down as well. And it looks like they're focusing onto Loon Shu, but Talon running really low as Hilo picks up a kill, picks up a double kill, picks up a triple kill. Hilo finally showing his stuff. Xerath doing tons of damage right there. A very nice play from the side of Wings of Freedom, and a bit greedy.
That was perfectly played. He hit all of his abilities. His Arcana Barrage and Pulse were spot on, and that's exactly what he needs to be just a big poke machine.
Definitely.
He got his first three kills of the game. He's farming fairly well, but he's taking a couple tower shots.
He's got those double buffs. He's not scared. As a Shockwave was used mid Dragon's Descent, as Talon actually going down, getting a bit too aggressive there. Kind of a little buzzkill after that big play there, as the Death Rocket takes Hilo down a bit of health as Ace in the Hole will come in, finish off Zero. Baby Chug picking that one up as Qui-Gon Jinn running extremely low as well. Will he be able to pick this up? Hilo getting his fourth kill in a row here as the ult from Xerath coming in, and Baby Chug picking up a double kill right here. The zap lands onto Herablo, but will he be able to escape this one? Looks like Karma will be able to pick this one up if the tether lands. Yes, it will, and the Ignite instead opting to auto attack or something else. But a nice turnaround from RDS there, but still Hilo getting four kills there, and two assists, actually, I believe it was. Two on Baby Trug's double kill.
Right. And Luke Duke maybe just got too excited for the kill for Hera. I mean, you saw him flash and then miss the Q, right? Which is unfortunate, but he was still in range to W, and I mean, he still could have sped himself up at that point to just tether, speed up right beside him, because, you know, Olaf doesn't have flash, he only has ghost, was down at the time, right? So he could have just sped up, tethered, and then dropped the Q. But, I mean, all in all, he still got the kill, which is fine.
Definitely. Very aggressive lane, as they're just going to take that mid tower, and Dragon is not up. I mean, they took that a while ago.
The mid tower means so much at this point in the game. It opens up, essentially, the enemy team's jungle. All the buffs. You have a third way to get into the jungle, and it's global gold, right? And experience. It's so important.
Definitely here. As it just looks like they're just switching Lunshu between... Luke Duke is up there as well? Yes. It looks like they're just switching, rotating them between lanes, taking out all the outer turrets, because it just takes Lunshu on Jinx just a few hits to take down these turrets, just because she's so strong, and with her minigun lair. Look how fast it's shooting right there. As Hilo coming top, and gets... that'd be Luke Duke. Sorry, I gotta know the names. Qui-Gon Jaina also caught... Getting a beautiful Dragon's Descent over the wall, but an Undertow does catch him, is slowed down quite a bit. Dominance is on to Talon right now, as Herablo chasing with that Ghost, but I don't think they can catch us. Shyvana very fast as well when that Burnout is running.
Yeah, Shyvana's just way too fast. Wow. Hera burned the Ghost, he's not going to be able to get Gungeon without staying his run.
There we go, yeah. There
finally backs off. I mean, it was a good pickup on Luke. He kind of hugged the wall way too close, and Hilo just punishing him for it, but... Yeah, it was just a misplay trying to siege the tower.
Definitely, both, you see the stars kind of coming out from each team, it looks like. RDS will have to focus Hilo, and Lunshu will be focused by Wings of Freedom, as it looks like this top tower will go down, but Jinx coming in right away will be able to do something. The zap does land onto Hilo, and this could be a lot of trouble here. Holy man, that does a lot of damage right there. As the E coming out, I believe, from Karma, speeding everyone up.
The Mantra E, it kind of works as the Talisman, and like I said, if she would have that and Talisman, it would be huge, but instead she opted for the Edge. Not necessarily what I would have went for, but I can understand it.
Her build, too, just going for that straight CDR as the Mega Rocket just comes in, and Hilo escapes with barely enough life.
Just the skin of his teeth.
Yes, holy. It was probably that skin that saved him, actually.
Oh, probably.
No red trinkets being pulled out for, and they're going for a 22-minute Baron RDS, Revolutionary Death Squad.
Yeah, they saw Caitlyn in the bot lane, right? So they figured, well, Hilo's chunked low, we hit him. Caitlyn is bot side, so it's potentially safe.
As the Dragon's Descent comes in, he's got the shield, just waiting for a command shockwave to be pulled out, but it looks like the team of Wings of Freedom has to back up, because they're all running pretty low right now, and they're having to use that wild growth on herself right here. Qui-Gon Jinn still chasing, though.
He's just way too tanky.
Exactly. And he's looking to build that Bork as well, so has a bit of damage to him. He's got that Bilgewater Cutlass right now, but as Dragon is live, and it looks like RDS knows that, and they're going to head over there right now. Wings of Freedom, I don't think, can contest that.
No, I like the Dragon call better than Baron. I mean,
definitely.
Baron was so gutsy at that point in the game, too. You're going to take so much damage, regardless if Maokai's going to help out, right? But... Yeah, it's just...
If Wings of Freedom show up at the right time, it's an ace, basically, so...
Yeah, I mean, they don't necessarily have the greatest teamfight comp. The only AoE really is from Hilo. So it's not the best idea for them to fight in tight quarters like a Baron pit.
That's true, yeah.
Because you have the Shockwave, and then you have two people who can jump on you and just group you all together.
Absolutely, but back to Luke Duke's build. What do you think about that? That just straight CDR, the Morellon Omicron... With the Ionian boots.
I like CDR on all champions. I think it's a valuable stat. But Karma doesn't necessarily need it. Her ability, like, her Q is already on a low enough cooldown, as it is. And the Morellon Omicron might be pushing it too much. I would like to see a Talisman from both supports, in my opinion.
Definitely, yeah.
Engage and disengage is just, it's so valuable.
Absolutely. I mean, maybe she's just going to rely on her Mantra E to do that for her, but... I mean,
Mantra's on like a 30-second cooldown, I think, at level 16.
I believe so, yeah, something around that, but, I mean, when you're 2-4 and you have 8 assists already, I mean, why not?
Why not?
Why not is the question.
Also, I believe Spell Thief's Edge also has an active.
At its max level?
No, even when you upgrade it, maybe in the max level too. It's like, it does damage and slow, right? So it's kind of like a Cutlass.
Okay, Yeah, just a supports version of a Cutlass there.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. So it's kind of fun. DPS item, you know, you can bork them until your AD carry and got them, I guess. But we'll have to see.
Trying to kill steal there as Hilo just using that to clear waves. Sorry if I may. Has 1,000 gold. I don't know what he's going to pick up here. Doesn't have too much money, but looks like they're all kind of back and maybe going to pick up a Giant's Belt. Actually, he's going to pick up that Blasting one just for a bit more AP. He's scary right now. He's got a most farm in the game.
Yep.
And 5 kills, and we've seen his ult is spot on.
Yeah, especially today. It's crazy. He's actually ahead in items of Orianna, which is dangerous because if he can get a pick, that person will be dead, especially with a death cap. That is a huge spike. Caitlyn has her Eye Edge and her Shiv now. So, tons of damage coming out of their carries at this point in the game. I know when I play AD carry, I usually have Eye Edge around 25 minutes right now. So, Baby Chug's not doing bad. I guess he's got an item up on me.
Yeah. Definitely Baby Chug. I believe Hilo's actually the one who's most comfortable in the AD carry position, is what I've heard from other teams and players.
Oh, is that right?
Who know him a bit better. So, I'm not 100% sure... I'm not 100% sure why they have Hilo in the mid lane. I mean, he's doing a fascinating job up there. If we look at the gold and the kills, it's actually a very close game. I've kind of been... my mind is in the set that RDS is winning this game. I mean, they have equal turrets, almost like 2-kill difference, and just like a less than 2k gold lead. So, this is anyone's game, realistically, right here.
Yeah, like, ever since 8 minutes, right, we saw that RDS had about a 1.5k lead, and they still have that lead. But Wings of Freedom are keeping the game very, very close. They're not giving up any more objectives and gold than they have to. They always trade kills for and objectives with RDS, so it's keeping them in the game for sure.
Absolutely here. As they're just grouping up right now, it looks RDS really wants a team fight here, I think.
And I like the call, because Maokai can just Twisted Advance. It's easy Shockwave on hopefully all 5. Same thing with Gonjin. He can just Free Willy in, and then, you know, the Shockwave comes in. Same thing. Hopefully 5, man. But at the same time, Wings of Freedom just kind of want to poke and siege, and that's, they don't really want a team fight because they don't really have a whole lot of AoE, as we touched on.
Exactly, yes. Also, another thing, although Wings of Freedom has those 11 kills, 3 of those coming on the support of Ender, who's first game is support with this in the Sask League, so not having the strongest game, I actually don't recall her getting those 3 kills. I remember a few, but
the flash EQ,
yeah, that was very nice.
That was very nice. Manly.
But so the gold spread is maybe a bit wonky on that side. So maybe although the gold is less than 1,000 or over 1,000. Oh my gosh, Hilo just one-shotting Luktuk right now, and they're gonna be looking for more. I don't know if they'll be able to chase right now. A talisman would be very useful.
Talisman would be pretty good right now. I mean, I don't think the Gonjin necessarily had to...
Oh my gosh, the 3-man shockwave from Zero right here, taking out 2 people combined with the rocket. That's a double kill for Lunshu, and that'll be a triple kill for Lunshu. That fight just turned around as Zero getting a kill and a quadra kill for Lunshu. What a play there from the side of RDS initially on the run, and they turn it around for an ace. Oh,
that was crazy. Zero with a perfectly placed ball shockwave. That was just outstanding. And this is what I was just going to touch on before it happened. I was going to say, just because Luktuk is down, they still have a really good team fight. They still have both of their tanks. They have the shockwave up, and they have their damage from Loon. Like, they don't have to necessarily be scared. So I didn't agree with Gonjin ultiing away. They could have surprised them as they did and ultied towards them and dropped the shockwave. And
they must have been reading your mind, because that's exactly what they did,
and it was perfect.
Wow, you're not gonna find a much better like little team fight, kind of like one shot team fight really than that right there. An impressive play.
Ace for one.
And yeah, that was surprising. I was caught off guard, so I can only assume that Wings of Freedom were as well, as the Oracle just being used to clean up. I know it's the Sweeping Trinket, the Baron Pit, Dragon up. Dragon is up right now, so...
Dragon is up, but the next objective on everyone's mind is Baron. It's 30 minutes. Mm-hmm. The team fight just went so well for RDS, and they're like, okay, we can win all the team fights now. We know we're stronger.
Yeah.
Even 4v5, right?
Yeah.
So...
Oh, man. Is Qui-Gon Jinn just going to clear out the war? Not scared of anything, as Luktuk going in. Are they going to catch Ender here? The Dragon's Descent is popping. Wild Growth used onto Talon, not Ender himself, and that's going to cost him his life. Yikes.
Possibly just, again, maybe a little misplay from Ender on his first support game, but I believe there's a key binding that you can use.
Alt Q or whatever it is.
Any of your skills that are selectable, then you can just put that on yourself.
Indeed.
It's pretty handy. I love to use it, especially when I support, because you can use it with a W, I believe. So instead of using it on your AD carry who's potentially going to die, use it on yourself, and then you say, whoops, misplay.
The selfish support from Wanden.
Yep.
Remind me never to play AD carry.
Okay, sounds good. And right now, we just see that they're going to take the in-hit. Fatboy Smoothie and Gungeon are just way too tanky.
They're taking skill shots and stuff and just losing so little amount of health compared to how many resources Wings of Freedom are using.
Parra tries to sidestep the chompers, but he can't.
They surprise you.
Yeah, too strong. So at this point, I would really like to see Wings of Freedom just post up and poke under a tower, but it's so scary, right? Because you have the Karma engage with the ball delivery system. It's anything could turn on you at this point. They're just too far behind. I just want them maybe to turtle and then eventually just push up and just
siege tower. Wait for late game, I guess, even though a rocket from Lunchu almost getting that kill, but
Baby Chog actually gets the dragon.
Oh man, so bit of miss. I mean, again,
Smite wasn't used, and Smite before season 4, it was kind of a big deal if you used Smite when people were about to contest a Baron, because you have to wait about the minute, right?
Yes.
But I believe Smite now is around 30 seconds?
40 seconds, I believe, initially. I don't know if there's much cooldown reduction and stuff. I could be wrong. I think it might be 30.
40?
40 seconds, there we go.
40 at level 15, okay.
There we go. I believe it's... Okay, yeah. Okay.
I don't know if it scales down, to be honest, but... Yeah, and it's not as a big deal if you use your Smite on Dragon, because they have to burn Baron almost instantly to make that Smite use kind of at a disadvantage for the other team, right?
Absolutely. So yeah, they did plan that to save the Smite and then go to Baron, but it does get spotted out there right away.
And Gungeon just pushing the mid lane. He wants the supers in the base, wants to rush it, and then Baron is... It should be free for RDS, because Wings of Freedom doesn't want to contest it. Their teamfight is so scary.
Yeah, there's nothing really Wings of Freedom can do. As Qui-Gon Jinn is turning on Rablo right now. Ragnarok pop from Rablo is going to back up. Hilo waiting to use his ult. Ooh, taking a bit of a chunk out of Lunchu.
And that's all they have to do. They just have to poke and avoid the teamfight. That's all they can really do at this point, because their tank, Hera, just got chunked on his own. His Ghost is down. His Ragnarok's down. He's not really... gonna run in there anymore, right?
Yeah, definitely not. You can't say, oh, Zero taking a bit of damage here. Gets the double shield from her ball and Karma.
They see that Baron's going down, though, so Wings are gonna respond instantly.
This could be the game changer, if anything, right here. If Wings of Freedom decide to fight, and they're not. So let's see what they do with this Baron buff right here. As it looks like Talon just getting melted really quickly. Wild Growth being put on him. The Shockwave actually landing as well. Ender picking up a kill on the other support. As the Dragon's Descent is coming down onto Hilo. As well as that would be Ender getting dying as well. Baby Trog just getting get chased down. A triple kill for Lunchu. Unreal. Zero pick up a kill onto Hilo right here. Hairblow, the only one standing. This could be an ace, and this could be game. It's pretty early to call, but... they can just push mid and possibly end right here.
30 second death timers. Gungeon push the supers already in mid, so they have enough time to end this game, especially with Jinx. She's just gonna shred these towers.
Definitely. This is looking like this will be game one in the two game series. RDS, Revolutionary Air Squad, taking it over Wings of Freedom.
I kind of say I'm surprised. I didn't expect the Jinx Karma lane to do better than the Kaylulu. I thought Kaylulu would have played much more passive, and. But no, Luke Duke was just spot on with the Mancha Q. He was poking them down and just giving Lunchu opportunities to execute them.
In a very good game. Again, Caitlyn and Lulu is considered a very safe lane. I mean, you're safe from all those pokes, safe from all those... you do the poking from far distance and stuff, so... I guess just... Yeah, I didn't expect... It was that team fight there, that Ori Ball and the Ace for one.
That was huge.
That was a game changer right there.
I feel like RDS had the game a little bit before, though. They had the better team fight for sure, but they just never tried to 5v5 at that point.
Yeah.
So they 4v5, that was the closest as they got, and then after that point, they were just so confident they were grouping and just wanted to 5v5 the whole time.
Absolutely, wow. A very good game from RDS, very well coordinated.
So, we're going to hop out a game, put it to some music, and we're going to get into game 2, and we'll be back shortly.
Alright, stay tuned. I'm like a firecracker. I make it hot when I put on.
Hey, probably hate to see your stupid face. Your stupid face. So here's to you, Mrs. Robinson. You live in an unforgiving place.
To borrow is to take and not return. I have borrowed all my lonesome life, and I can't, no, I can't get through. The borrower's debt is the only regret of my youth.
Welcome back. This is Game 2, Sask Law League. Wednesday night?
Yeah, that means it's week 4, day...
Dos.
Dos. Like, we're Spanish now.
Hola, señor, señorita.
As Ziggs gets banned here from the... Sorry, RDS versus Wings of Freedom Game 2. If you didn't watch Game 1, you can watch the VOD or I'll tell you who wins, and it was RDS, actually.
Oh, you're supposed to drop the spoiler alert, man.
Well, I kind of did. I warned him.
But you, like, gave him 2 seconds to be like, oh my god, he's going to spoil.
Well, sorry. It's a very good game. There's an amazing team fight that goes on. You have to watch it. You have to watch it. Jinx being a band away from Lunchu. Great job from Wings of Freedom realizing that. That was pretty obvious that was going to happen, but...
So in last pick ban phase... By the way, RDS is now blue side.
Yes.
Game 1, they were purple side, so... We talked about RDS being Purple Team and having to ban Zigzagragus because the potential steal from Wings of Freedom, right? But now they're blue side, they get the first pick, they could pick either of those. But now we know Zero doesn't play Zigzagragus, otherwise it would have left it up and potentially first picked it, right?
That's true, so...
So it hurts RDS in a sense that they don't play the OP mid right now.
Yeah, that Zero's not... doesn't have the biggest champion pool.
Right. But, I mean, it still worked out. His Orianna did the job.
Oh, definitely, against Hilo Xerath, which he does very good with, and he had a good game.
He played the lane really, really well.
Definitely. Their team fighting, I think they're... It looked like RDS was really on par with the decision-making. Whoever the shot caller is doing a very good job.
Yeah, the team fight comp was just superior to Wings of Freedom's team at that point.
Absolutely, definitely.
Plus, the early game skirmishes didn't really help to put them ahead, but...
I wonder if Fatboy Smoothie is going to take that Maokai again. As I say that, it does get locked in right there. Wow. Locked. He's been doing phenomenal in that, and that's a chant that you don't really see a heck of a lot of, but, I mean, Fatboy Smoothie's making it work. I gotta go try Maokai out when I get home.
He's a fun jungler. I mean, you can throw a sapling, and then you can twist an advance to it, so you kind of can jump through walls that way, right? Talon again playing Ren. His Ren, game one, it had a tough time in lane. Ren's supposed to be a big lane bully, but unfortunately he wasn't really too impactful in the game.
Yeah, that's an interesting pickup, and as the Thresh being hovered over for Luke, and that's the sacrifice they had to make. So ban Jinx, give up Thresh is kind of the what happened there. We'll see if he picks that, and Elise also being picked up from the side of Herablo.
Wings of Freedom.
Wings of Freedom, yes. Herablo on Wings of Freedom, yes.
I really like the pick. Elise is so scary in the jungle right now.
Absolutely.
I like it a lot better than the Olaf jungle myself. That's just personal preference. Mm-hmm. But, oh, we see Karma instead of the Thresh.
That's dangerous, and I'm sure Wings of Freedom aren't going to like that if that gets locked in. And Shyvana again, sorry.
If it does get locked in, though, I feel like Wings of Freedom, like we talked about, it should learn from the game one. And then they say, okay, I can beat Karma in lane now. I know what I need to do. Baby Trog and Ender, they're a brand new bot lane, like we said, with Talon going up to the top lane now. But I still think the veterancy from Ender as an AD carry down into support now will help Baby Trog get through the lane and then essentially carry the game later.
Absolutely. And you could tell from last game, Ender had some AD carry-like qualities. He was playing very aggressive. That first blood, he just walked up almost, like... He gave him the kill, but he playing very aggressive, probably not used to playing as much support.
I believe there's a video on YouTube. Ender just tried to give Baby Trog... How is it worded? It's something in the lane. Dominance? No, that's not it. I can't think of it.
Who are we talking about?
Afro on Leona. That video. Have you seen it?
I don't think so.
I'm going to need a new caster if any of you are available
okay.
For game two.
Okay. Okay.
Presence in the lane!
Presence in the lane. Oh, no, I saw that.
Saw that. Okay, now he's saying, just because I said it,
no,
of course.
No, I have. And Aframoose swears quite a bit. I've seen that one.
Wow, okay, this guy. Just because now he's dropping over, like, oh my god.
Oh, man.
Anyways, though, I feel like Ender was just trying to give presence, right? He was trying to say, look, I'm here, I'm too, don't mess with our AD carry bot lane, right? Mm-hmm. But... RDS, they hit two right away, and they just went all in.
And that potentially could have just been the changing point for that bottom lane.
Exactly, honestly. Right? It put the poke lane ahead, and then it was just so hard to come back. I mean, Karma's just so annoying, especially in level one.
Exactly. Brand, Hilo taking Brand as well.
It looks like the same team comp's going to be coming out of RDS.
Just let's see what the AD carry is going to be, because they don't have Jinx. Any good substitutes before in the next 10 seconds? Looks like Lucian.
I think Lucian would be really, really good here.
I mean, very... Almost similar to Jinx's, like, they're both the flavor of the month kind of thing. They're both very strong. The two probably strongest AD carries right now.
Yeah, Lunshu... No. Sorry.
Yep.
Sivir. Okay, Sivir's fine, too.
Yeah.
Sivir with her ulti. Okay, they're all in rush the back line.
Wow.
Sivir ulti, and then the Mantra E. Hopefully a Talisman. I would love to see a Talisman come out of supports. Definitely. I think it's a lot better than the Edge myself.
Yes.
Because Edge late game isn't going to do anything.
Yeah, exactly.
And it's just going to help the ball delivery system out that much more, right? So this is really interesting. I want to see how Wings of Freedom do against this team. Because it's kind of like RDS took their old comp and then bumped it up a little bit with Sivir ulti. But
Absolutely,
Sivir's laning isn't necessarily the strongest either. But Ezreal's not going to be able to punish her. He's not really a bully. But Blitz, though.
I want to see a Blitzcrank. I find Blitz, besides Karma, the most annoying. I think most people do. Though, I know, you just have to learn to play it completely differently, I think.
It'll be really, really interesting because Blitz's lane is really, really weak. I mean, you miss a hook, you do nothing for 20 seconds,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, exactly.
And then Luke Duke will punish you for it. He's very aggressive. He's going to Mantra Q all the time. And if that hook misses, you're putting your lane at a disadvantage for 20 seconds. Like, you don't necessarily see a lot of Blitz for that reason because his laning is so weak, and the meta right now is just for supports to make plays and always be that presence, right? Like, that's why we see Leona, Annie, Thresh, typically.
Yeah, the trifecta of the supports right there, yeah.
Right. I play them all. Teams pick me up.
Oh, yeah. A little shameless advertising.
I don't know what that means. That's not me.
We had a comment in our comment section, not really the Twitch chat, saying the finals are on March 23rd at the Matrix.
I have to book that still.
Yes, you should ASAP.
Well, I called them before the tournament started, and they said, "Whoa, that's a long tournament." I was like, "Yeah, of course, I'm doing like a season, right?"
Yeah.
But they said to just give them a call later on as closer the season progresses. Yeah.
I mean, we still got a lot of time. Also, we're in talks with Access 7 right now, a local film television program. Don't get your hopes too high. We just are in a bit of talks with them, so this could be like on air, and we also wanted to get on Twitch as well.
This being the season, the regular games, the finals, or the grand final?
The finals, I believe. Yes, the one at the Matrix.
You can tell by his certainty in the voice that he knows which games.
I'm gonna have to think a bit, alright?
Okay, so the grand final, the 23rd, at the Matrix.
Yes.
Will potentially be on TV.
Yes. Access 7 has done a few, like StarCraft 2. I think little, like, tournaments or whatever they do.
Whatever StarCraft 2 is. It's all about League, right?
Yeah, exactly. I don't even know what that is.
I believe it's like an RTS, but...
Yeah, it looked very confusing when I watched it. Thursday's at 11 p.m., so Central Standard Time, so that's half an hour tomorrow.
Shameless plug!
I just really want it. I think it'd be cool.
No, yeah, it'd be really, really sweet if we were able to get the finals. Like, the grand finals, the last day, the best of five against the top two teams.
Hey, might as well just televised. Put the semifinals in there as well.
I mean, why not? We might as well do it all. Anyway.
Yeah, well, that's rest of the season.
Access, just stream for us. Please.
Okay, back to the... As we wait for our spectator delay, really quickly, team comp-wise, I think it's... Well, I mean, it's pretty much the same from RDS, and I think
I know where you're going with this.
Yeah.
And I'm going to say RDS still.
Yes.
RDS's team comp, in my mind, it's like 2.0. The Sivir is just going to help them get to that monster team fight that they had
Absolutely.
Before. And I don't necessarily see Blitzcrank as opposed to Lulu paying off that much. I mean, it'll help in lane, hopefully, but he has a weak laning phase. But the late game picks won't necessarily help out because Gonjin and Smoothie are just going to be that front line. And if you pull them, then it's like you did the job for me.
Exactly,
to get to
they
the
were going there anyway.
Yeah, exactly. So I don't necessarily agree with the Blitzcrank pick, but for that matter, I pick RDS game 2.
I agree with you there. I mean, it's the same team comp and they destroyed last time, so. I mean, that's.
Wings of Freedom's team comp is very confusing to me almost. I'm not sure. Maybe win lane, win game. Type of thing.
I think that's what they're going for, risk it for the biscuit kind of thing.
Yeah, there you go. Sayings going everywhere. But Twitch chat, game 2, lay it on us. What do you think? Clearly, 1-1. 1-1's the hope.
Yeah,
but team comp-wise, and what we saw last game anyways, unless Wings of Freedom don't give an answer to that team fight, it's going to be all over again, yeah.
Also, I'm just thinking, I don't know how is... the Blitz and Ezreal combo, because usually with Blitz you want someone, I don't think it's that great, because you want someone with either a lot of burst or like a stun, like with a Jinx or something, because then you can lay those chompers down, or so Yordle Snaptrap or whatever those are called, down under
the
Caitlyn
feet. Traps, right?
Yes.
But you're not going to lane Caitlyn with Ez. Come on!
No, with Blitz.
Oh!
Blitz, you don't do that.
So
you just Blitz, you just Blitz gets the hook, you put a snap trap under.
And then knock up.
Yeah.
And then they eat the trap.
Yeah, so...
You just don't play Blitz. That's how it goes.
I really like him. I think he's really fun.
I just say that because I'm awful at Blitz, though. Okay, skin win. Not
I think
Hank
it's your turn.
It's my turn?
I did last game.
Well, it's always the Hank 1 thing, so technically you are Hank 1 for this evening.
How does he talk? I had my impersonation down earlier. I can't do it. I'll do it later.
Okay.
I might pull it out halfway through the game.
Yeah. I mean, you just don't call upon it, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, okay. I understand. I'll take over then. I love Zombie Brant. I know it came back, and Victorious Elise, that's the only skin that I like of Elise's. Granted, it's either that or her other one. I don't know what it's called.
I can't remember what it's called, but yeah.
Rune Wars is always good. I like Rune Wars. Victorious, I like. Zombie, I like. Frosted's fun. Blitz has a lot of fun skins. I don't blame Ender. He just started playing support,
yeah,
right?
Exactly.
So I'm not gonna go, screens, sorry. I'm not gonna go all crazy about it, but yeah, I like the Wings of Freedom's skin too.
Absolutely. So they're favored to win this game right here. Yeah, Victorious Elise, I think it just looks so like prestigious. And I love Festive Maokai though. I mean, how can you not? I mean,
but Totemic though, he's showing off the skins. I mean, if you have Totemic and Festive, I agree. Festive's like 100% number one skin.
Yeah.
I don't know why you bust out Totemic. Maybe Mystery Gifted. And he just wanted to be like, hey, Zero, thanks for the good or bad skin, depending on how he likes it, I suppose.
I guess depending on their friendship. And it looks like RDS is looking to go to that red right away.
I really want Wings of Freedom to level 1, because that's what you do with Blitz. You pick Blitz.
Yep.
His level 1 is just so scary. The hook. Oh, smoothie,
that was smoothie. Might get caught out here, and the hook should come out. He doesn't even need it.
He doesn't even need it.
And a missed Arcane Barrage, I believe that was, from Babytron, but they still pick up the kill. That is Herablow, the jungler, picking up the kill against the opponent jungler, Fatboy Smoothie. They're going to put a ward down, just like they did last game.
I really like that Ender held on to his hook.
Yeah, that was...
There was no point to use it. I mean, Smoothie just walked back into Wings of Freedom. He didn't want to flash over the red buff. He was scared that the hook was just going to get him anyways, which, it's a gamble, right? You could flash and then you can kind of sidestep and hope to juke, but I like that Ender held on to his hook.
Absolutely, yeah.
Assuming that's what he took anyways.
Oh, yeah, I guess we haven't even... Yeah, he did. I mean, I guess you could take the knockup, but there's not much else.
Yeah,
let's look at the support items, though. We have the Spell Thief's Edge.
And finally, the coin.
So, this
the talisman!
This says two things, yes. Hopefully that builds into a talisman. That Wings of Freedom want more of a passive bot lane, because the longer they stay in that bot lane, the more money Ender's going to get, making a bigger difference.
Right.
But that means Luke Duke, with that Spell Thief's Edge, wants to play a lot more aggressive, getting that gold for hitting the enemy champions.
And that fits his playstyle, right? Luke Duke's
Absolutely.
Very aggressive on Karma.
So yeah, this is going to be... It's just like complete opposites right here, so we'll have to see...
John! But no, I really like... By the way, Coin only builds into Talisman for Endo.
Yes. No, well, some people don't build it all the way. That's what I'm saying. I mean...
Why not?
I mean...
It's so good.
I know.
Come on, Woloshin.
Hey, I main support Thresh, you know. Woloshin, you... Silver 2, add me.
I'm not even ranked anymore.
Last season, I should say. I'm not ranked either right now.
Fun fact, actually.
Okay.
I was in a ranked in season 2 with Void Boy's Smurf account.
Actually?
Yeah, but he was on the other team. I was watching a stream at the time, and I was completely freaked out because, you know, at that point, like, Elo meant everything to me, right?
Yeah.
So
yeah.
I was like, I don't want any of this, so I just dodged Q.
No, you didn't.
I didn't want to lose.
You're such an idiot.
No. He was playing Vayne. Hyper carry.
That's true, but still.
Anyways, I was intimidated back in the day, but...
Oh, man, I'm thinking I might just leave right here. That's, like...
That'd be awkward.
An honor to... Oh! The max range hook! Oh, the Luke, and he might not be able to escape this one. The Tether goes on to Babytron, who flashes away and gets healed pretty big, actually, kind of thing. They're going on to Lunchu, sorry. And they're going to back up. A nice play, nice little peel there from the side of RDS, but a max range hook.
That was monster hook. However, the exhaust was a little bit late. Lunchu did all the bursts on the autos, and then exhaust came down, right?
Yeah.
Ender, again, new to the support role, he could have potentially exhausted Luke, and, I mean, Luke still burned flash, but the exhaust is always good because it slows him down and it helps the kill.
It's like a guaranteed hook or knock-up or whatever you want, really.
Right, exactly. He already hit that, so he could use it just for the follow-up damage to happen.
Yeah.
However, that or just use the exhaust, so Baby Chog is in 1/3 health right now as well, so... A little bit of misplay, but also a really good hook.
Absolutely, and that would have really been big because they got that first blood, so both of them in the bot lane have that assist, and getting a kill and another assist down there would have been quite huge. Talon's just actually kind of getting bullied out here by Kawhi, who's doing a fabulous job in lane up top.
It's exactly game one all over again. It's the same top lane matchup. Mm-hmm. Gonjin's abusing Talon, possibly because he's a brand new top laner to the SLL, yes, of course, right? Yeah. So, oh, the veterancy is just showing, and he's pushing the lane, he's not scared at all. Ender's trying to get a cheeky grab in the same spot again.
Yeah. Just looking for that. If it worked once, it, fool me once, shame on you, whatever that thing is.
Fool me twice, shame on me.
Aha.
Come on, that was easy. The you said like half of it.
Okay, well, I want. That's what casters do.
Oh my god.
I'm trying to make you look smart here, alright? No, you are smart.
Trying. Oh, I see, I see, yeah.
As we want to keep an eye on RDS's CS.
Excuse me?
RDS's CS.
Oh, okay, okay. I thought maybe it was like a word float there, but...
No, no worries, I got this.
I was hoping, like, nah.
They've been focusing on getting 100 CS by 10 minutes. Doesn't look like that way right now. And there's not as much action going on, so we'll see how everything's going to turn out. But they're really focusing on, yeah, getting that 100 CS by 10 minutes.
Ender can play really aggressive here. He can just W and then run at them and punch.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
I mean, Luke Duke has a speed up to get away, and then Loon also has a spell shield, so it's like, eh, what are you going to do to us, right?
That's true.
But he could play aggressive. I think maybe he just wanted Hera to come down and help out the gank.
Yeah, it looks like Herablow's actually backing... does back right there, as Fatboy Smoothie's looking to come mid. It looks like possibly drops that ward down. It's not warded on the bot side, so Hilo's going to have to play a bit safe, as Fatboy Smoothie might be looking for a gank ASAP here, and he looks like he's going in. Left-hand mouse. Oh, I'm the worst. And whoa, backs up. Wow. I don't
use... I love this camera angle.
Wow.
It was pretty good, though. I mean,
thank you. I mean, we needed to see...
The spotlight on Hilo was... It was nice. It was a nice gesture.
A ward being placed down... Or is he coming for a roam? It looks like...
Yeah, Hilo's 6. He wants the kill on bot lane. And I like the call. Hera's also bot as well.
Yeah, let's get to that right away.
RDS has no idea.
They are backing up, though. Oh, there we go. We see a Mia ping being placed out there.
In the try. Baby Chopper's trying his best to bait it, being half health, half mana.
Yes.
But RDS, they were like, yo, this smells fishy.
It smells fishy.
And there's no fizz in the game, so I mean, something's going on.
Something's up. Some more trading. The one thing I don't like about this, we usually keep it on directed camera unless we see something. I've said this in my recordings as well, is... It goes like to wherever the action is, and since there's constant trades going in the top lane, it focuses a lot on the top lane, which I don't like. But I mean, there's not much we can do. It was decent last game though.
Yeah, last game was not too bad. I mean, top lane was kind of... top lane's always boring. Oh yeah, it's to be honest.
Yeah, some people are pretty upset about that. They want a change in the meta, even though this is one just kind of began.
Yeah,
this
pretty
top
much,
lane
yeah.
Tank, extreme tanks. Like they were always kind of... there was the Shen and stuff. I remember when Shen was popular. Those were the days. Like last season.
Like last week.
Yeah, okay.
Talon's very, very squishy at this point in the game.
Absolutely, he's got that assist, so let's see how much gold he has. Oh, I pressed the wrong button. He's got less gold than his counterpart, I guess, for being down 8 CS. As the cocoon misses, but a flash! Oh. I don't think that was necessary, but Zero playing it really safe.
In my opinion, it was necessary because Brand's damage at 6 is pretty scary.
That's true.
And then Elise, her single target damage is crazy. She did miss her cocoon, but her double Q being human and then spider form, is so much damage. Her spider form Q is also an execute, right? So
yeah.
Hilo gets her low enough, ignites drop, and then just
that's
the
true.
Spider Q, repel up, boom. See
I guess
ya.
That's why these guys are playing, and I'm not, but these guys very all very skilled. If you're not sure what this league is, this is the Saskatchewan League of Legends League. It's an amateur tournament for people in Saskatchewan or the kind of the surrounding areas, but the finals are in Regina, live. Oh my gosh, sorry, that's Qui-Gon Jinn actually going to chase Herablow out of his own jungle.
And he's forced to flash and then go into spider form just in case he needs to repel to some damage.
Absolutely, wow. But it looks like Talon and Hilo are coming in. Fatboy Smoothie taking his time as Dragon's Descent.
Gonjin's gone crazy!
He's gone crazy. And will he be able to escape this, though? It doesn't look like it. And it looks like Tiz, a laner, will pick it up. And that's good. Yes, it's a one for one.
That and Talon, he needed something in that lane. He was having a hard enough time against Shyvana game one. Same thing game two. But now he's got a red buff and kill. That's pretty big.
Yeah.
That'll help him turn the lane around, hopefully. I mean, Red's just such a big bully, especially on Ren, right? He is a bully. So it's exactly. Like having two bullies in one person.
Like having a few U's. Because you're a bully sometimes, then.
Wow. I know nothing about that. So in mid lane, we just see Hilo just playing the lane really, really well. He's farming very well on Brand. Brand's pretty easy to farm with his pillar, however.
Absolutely, but still doing a good job.
Yeah, exactly. Putting pressure on the map when it needs to be.
Yeah, he tried that failed roam earlier on, but he walked actually right over a ward in mid lane and the bottom mid brush. I think that's how they spotted him out real quick.
RDS's wards have been really, really good.
Absolutely, but maybe not too good because it looks like a dragon is going to be coming out the side of Wings of Freedom, and it looks like no one in RDS is near to contest this. This will be the first dragon our Wings of Freedom have got, so...
They see it just going down, so RDS does have the timer, give or take. But Herod tanked the duration of that dragon. You can get the spiders to tank buffs and dragons for you. You just have to double back, get the spiderlings closer, and then you don't take as much damage, so...
There's actually a video, and I saw it was recently just using the, like, as Ender actually takes us, yes, there. Where you can just have two people or one person attacking the dragon.
Right.
The second person running into the dragon's, like, closest to the dragon, so it focuses him, then running out, and it won't attack you if you do it right. It's super tough, as it looks like some trading going on in the bot lane. Ender playing really aggressive, knocks him, balloon shoot, but Baby Trog is running pretty low, and Ender's just gonna W out of there.
Yeah, I was hoping that he wasn't gonna hook Loon in.
Yeah.
Because... Baby Trog was already low. He didn't want to get hooked in and just die, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, he's got to play pretty safe here.
So I the bottom lane is definitely coming along for Wings of Freedom this game.
A lot better than the last game, that's for sure. As this top lane, though, still down almost 20 CS as Herablu's coming in for a gank. That cocoon way off with the Dragon's Ascent used, so...
But he was stunned. Ren stunned him. What is this?
This is a game-breaking bug, as it looks like Ender's going in, but it does not see Fatboy Smoothie coming in. The silence coming out, but I don't think that's going to be enough. Loonshu taking the kill onto Ender.
I don't know how Ender missed the hook. That was, like, point blank, and it seemed like it went through, like, three champions.
I actually didn't see him throw out the hook. Wow. Looks like Ender needs to back up. Sorry, that's Baby Truck needs to back up as the cocoon lands onto Kawhi and is stunned from Talon as well. The Ignite is popped onto Kawhi Gungeon. They need to get this Dominance as well is being used from Talon. He's got a bit more health. Gonna let Herablu take. They need to... They're not going for this.
They're not going for the kill, the miscommunication. Talon wanted to all in, Hera didn't. And then Talon was taking tower, and he got a little scared, but his Dominus and his health pool was so big, he could have tanked and just essentially dove. But yeah, a little miscommunication possibly gave up a kill, because they committed fairly hard to that.
Absolutely, yeah.
Both summoners burned on Talon.
Yeah, that's pretty rough right there. As during that, we had, RDS take a tower in the bot lane. And... Yeah,
that was from the big gank from Smoothie, right? He was in
the brush there.
That Loon spell shielded the punch, I believe, from Ender. Okay. So it kind of baited Ender out of the tower. And then Smoothie just came in with a Twisted Advance. They all inned, and they got him. It was really well played.
Yeah, Fatboy Smoothie having a nice gank. I didn't see him there until that we actually went down there. So fooling the enemy team, fooling the casters. Well,
caster.
Caster, me at least.
Yeah.
Talon's gonna back, see what he buys. He's got some magic resist right now, as it looks like a Sunfire Cape will be the first pickup from Kawhi Gungeon once he has enough gold right there, as the blue buff being transferred over to Hilo and Ender going mid for a bit of a gank here. I think Hilo calling for some help as the W is prop from Ender and the knock-up onto Kawhi Gungeon and the pull right there, but they can't really touch him right now. He's just too strong.
Yeah, you don't want to necessarily pull Gungeon into your team, especially with Oiri beside him, right? Yeah. That's pretty scary.
that's rough. As we just get confirmation that Jug 2-1-2-0 over TNG.
Congratulations to Jug. They are still undefeated in the SASC League.
Someone's got to beat him.
14-0. Their time is due. They've had their run. However, a little tangent from the game. The 14 games, Jug has played all the teams thus far. Yes. So now the season is going to replay, and they're going to have to play all the teams again.
Okay, yes.
But they've beaten all the teams thus far.
Indeed, so...
So they've proven their skill, and the question is anyone going to step up and surpass that to defeat Jug?
Again, Jug, one of those teams that... I think if there's one team that studies more than RDS, it would be Jug. I know Predinchuk spends his days... Instead of going to school, instead of working, he just watches VODs and he's winning this tournament. This is... Predinchuk actually stopped going to school to play in this tournament. Little neat fact for you.
Oh, really?
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah. So, I mean, these are amateur players, but they're playing to win here. So...
Oh, Hera just missing the cocoon, and Gonjin wants to go in. He's got the ball on him.
With that defensive mechanism on it, as the hook...
It was a beautiful hook.
And just gets blown up by the pillar there from Hilo.
That was an amazingly placed pillar.
Luke Duke flashed at the same time he got knocked up, so that flash actually kind of got negated, so... I guess a badly timed flash and a nicely timed knock-up from Ender.
Actually, his flash still went off. He got knocked up in the flash distance, right?
Okay.
So the distance was still gained, but yeah, Hilo just...
Oh, the ult coming in, but buried, and they stay away from each other, sorry. Yes.
Really well played.
Yeah, very nice job. And Hilo not giving
it. Hilo's taking the tower, yeah, he's...
He doesn't care.
He's playing man brand today.
As they're gonna get the tower, the command shockwave coming in, Ender running extremely low, that mana barrier... Just gonna give him enough health to die instantly.
Only hits Ender, though. The shockwave only hits one.
Yes, so worth? Question mark? Has the flash coming in from Zero. The flash also coming in from Hilo to get away. Maybe Trog running low. He has the arcane shift. Ezreal's very tough to catch. His Luke Duke running extremely low. That shield from Zero really saved his life right there. As they need to protect this mid-tower, it looks like. Oh my gosh, Hilo hitting hard.
Hilo's definitely hitting his skill shots when he needs to. Yeah, he's poking them down, and that was kind of the idea last game, right, with Xerath. He wanted to poke them down to, like, deter them from the team fight.
Not sure what just happened there. Qui-Gon Jinn just choosing to surpass. I think he could take them. He has Dragon Sand.
Oh, tabbing is a thing, too.
That's true, yeah. You want to check your Facebook.
Actually, fun fact... No, I'm not going to lay this one on the stream. Maybe after the stream.
Okay.
Because it's not really League related at all. It's essentially just a fun fact.
Could be caught. The ult used from Hilo, but doesn't do too much.
Disconnection issues, I was going to say.
That hook is coming out from Ender, it looks like.
Yeah, I was going to say, it looks like some disconnection issues, because Smoothie...
Yes.
I don't think he wants to still seeing
just
a brand thing.
Yeah, exactly.
So far, so good. We've had two games and two pauses.
Yeah, I mean, that just shows connection issues are great.
I'm sure in the Sask League area, there's probably someone just cutting all the internet wires.
Yeah, there's this hacker group called, what are they, the Derp Trolling? They DDoSed.
I believe it's, what is it? Not Walash, and it's something of that, though. It's Doralotion or something like that.
Something along those lines. Yeah. DDoSing all these players from the game.
Yeah, I know nothing about it. If you have any idea who these Doralotions are, then please, we would love to know so we don't have as many pauses in our games.
Yeah, absolutely. Just a FYI, this is not me in the chat, though it is
It is your account.
It is my account.
So this is awkward.
So yeah, I don't know who it is, but... Just don't listen. It sounds like it's Dreghost, a Bronze 5 player. Actually, he's not even ranked.
Well, yeah, the reset, right?
Yeah, the reset. Still level 19, but yeah, the reset.
But you can't play ranked at 19.
Yeah, exactly.
But
you know, so just a heads up, I'm not being really cocky, trying to resume. The game's gonna resume. As the hook misses, wow.
And Smoothie actually lives.
We forgot to go in the Skype call again. And check, because... If you're not aware, when pauses occur in like the LCS and stuff, they need to... They're not allowed to communicate with each other.
And they're not allowed to look away from their monitor, actually, which I found out last week. Yeah, they have to look directly at the monitor. They can't look over and say, oh, hey, I can see where you are.
Exactly, because that's what you get, like, depending... Because you could just, you know, it's like a phantom injury in like football or something, which happens all the time, but...
Dependency?
Sorry?
Tiberius?
As we continue with this game, I'm not sure what my cool caster is saying here. It's kind of...
You said dependence, right?
Nope.
Didn't you?
Nope.
Oh. I know a couple players that have, like, their name is... Regardless!
Oh my gosh, Luke Duke running really low. And this dragon gonna be taken.
Almost stolen, though.
Yeah, that was very nice blade coming out from Sivir there.
A really good smite, however, from Hera. The smite spider Q is...
Yeah.
It's good. It's kind of like the Lee Sin Q.
Yeah, the execute kind of thing. That was Qui-Gon Jinn getting stunned up here, but the burnout's just gonna put a lot of damage back onto Talon, but...
Gonjin's got red.
Yeah, this
red
is gonna be tough.
Red buff is pretty scary,
Taking down 2/3 of Talon's health right there.
No, because I thought you said dependence, and then I know.
I think I said phantom injury.
Oh, that's not. That doesn't have a D in it anyway.
No, it doesn't. As Ender's coming in, dragging his sense away.
Because yeah, there's a player, isn't there? Yeah, okay. They're good guys though. I've played a couple games with them. I played actually a tournament with them. Dependency and Tiberius. They're good folk.
In League?
Yeah.
Oh, well, shout out to those guys. As for Apple getting caught, but is gonna repel that chain right there as the hook misses. And the Q from
Duke is dodging all the skill shots. The speed, the extra speed is just so nice.
Yeah, definitely. It's gonna be a team based on speed. As we look, it looks like that'd be Luke Duke. Getting that Morello Nomicon is looking like what he's building towards again, because he's got that Athene's Codex, or that's not what it's called, but the Codex of something.
Yeah, no, it's Athene's Codex.
Is it?
No, wow. It's not.
I guess we'll mouse over it.
He messes up the screen.
Fiendish Codex.
It was kind of close.
Yeah, and the word Codex in there. Oh my gosh.
Codex is all that really mattered.
They have the Codex there.
I mean, it's known by Codex as opposed to Fiendish if you want to have one word associated to it. So I honor that.
Oh, well, thank you. And from the other side, we have a Sightstone being picked up. Like your standard support build, I'd say, from
Ender's build this game. He's potentially also going to go for an Aegis, which we actually don't really see much anymore in League as a whole, but it works because Gon Jin has a lot of magic damage through his burnout. Ori, of course, magic damage. Karma is all magic damage.
The exhaust being put on Qui-Gon Jinn. And the knockup mid Dragon's Descent that cancels it as Dominance is being puffed from Talon, who has to flash away. Nice flash, dodges the hook, but the Ignite will not take him. As we got some action in the bottom lane, is Herablo going to take down Lunshu, who uses the barrier and her ult to get away? And there's not action going here, so why is Director Camera taking us there? But it looks like in the top lane there, Ender chasing a bit too far, and is going to get leashed and take a tower shot. As Lunshu also getting running real low, the cocoon misses a nice dodge there. Elise, auto-attack? Was that auto-attack, sorry?
Auto-attack and then Q finish.
Okay, there we go. So a nice play there. As the top turret also gets taken, RDS was on the run, and they were. And Wings of Freedom just caught up. And
could you say they were running to the hills?
I could.
Run to the hills.
Why don't you play any of that good music during break?
Because break's over now.
Well, play I'm Blue or Bill Nye the Science Guy. I think that's the crowd favorite.
Bill Nye the Science Guy.
You know the theme song.
Oh, okay. I understand now.
Bill Nye the Science Guy. We got it. Wow.
Yeah, okay.
Wow.
I'm a science major.
Yeah, I knew that. You have to. That's going to be your final.
That's my theme song, actually. Yeah. In my final, that's all I have in my earbuds. That's all I play.
As we see, Qui-Gon Jinn looking to take this turret. Helo coming in. Misses that Q there. The Pillar of Fire also being missed. Qui-Gon Jinn just dodging a lot of these skill shots here.
They're putting a lot of focus on Gon Jinn this game.
They are. They're focusing him down. As Ender comes in, gets the knockup, and don't think Qui-Gon Jinn will be able to escape this one. The burnout is going. And just going to try surviving this one as long as they can. RDS needs to respond, though. They sent three top. They need to get this turret or something quickly. Good job by Herablo. Taking over mid lane. And there's no minions here for RDS to push this tower.
So. There was a ton of damage coming out of Hera from his human form Q. Luke went down late from 80 to 60.
Absolutely, yeah.
He took a ton of damage. Elise's base damage is crazy. Plus, she's got the Haunting Guise now, so she's just going to pen.
Yeah.
Along with the Sork Boots. Oh, man!
Oh, my gosh.
Damage.
This game might be over.
Damage Elise. It'll be good. Actually, we do see a pretty decent gold lead for Wings of Freedom. We see a 4K gold lead for them.
Yeah. This game. So this is good. I always enjoy when 1-1 splits. Not saying that it's gonna be. It's still very early in the game. As it looks like the supports are gonna duke it out. Just kidding. Ender's gonna, or both of them are gonna run away from that.
Would you say they're gonna Luke duke it out?
Wow, you're on today with the puns.
Thank you.
Wow.
Thank you.
That's can we get some HHCs in the comments for that?
HHC.
We'll get a few of those in 3.5 minutes when the stream delay is over.
Well, it's like 5.
Is it?
Well, for the people in-game, because we have a 3-minute delay here.
Oh, that's right.
But there's only a 2-minute delay from the stream, so it's actually a 2-minute delay for the people that are hopefully going to chant the HHC.
HHC. So, Huntail Hard Carry, if you're not sure. Huntail is basically the Mad Life of the Sasquatch League, as that middle turret does go down a while ago, but just going to bring that up now. And it looks like they're... good award, Baron, but obviously not the smart choice. It was at this time last game that RDS attempted their first Baron. They backed up pretty quickly, but...
And I like that they backed up, because the Baron in 20 was absolutely terrifying. And yeah, I'm notorious for bad Baron calls, by the way.
Oh, definitely. I've played a few games with you.
And it's, yeah, it's just, it's not good, so...
Yeah, no, I've wanted to strangle you, yep.
Wow.
You know, Blitzcrank... What support? Who's doing better support? Despite looking at the scores, Ender's having a huge impact this game. He's been top a few times. He's like a second jungler almost, and a Blitz jungle is something to be scared of.
Ender's playing Blitz really, really well because he's been roaming all over the map. I like his item builds. Bills? Item builds.
Yeah,
sorry.
He does have a lot of bills, I guess, with his electricity he uses.
He's got a lot of money from his assists.
Exactly, and they get that and from dragons that they get, that's going to secure a 5k gold lead for the side of Wings of Freedom.
They've had a gold lead, to my knowledge, at this whole point in the game. And from what we saw last game, RDS had the gold lead for all points in the game. And then they ended up winning the game. So right now, in my opinion, it's Wings of Freedom's game to lose because they're just ahead right now.
Exactly. I believe someone's calling you out in the comments section.
Science is science. I'm not going to lie.
Which begs the question, is there a difference? Sorry, as Fatboy Smoothie gets the command, Shockwave hits two people, and it looks like people are being melted instantly, but I can't really see. Fatboy Smoothie gets killed, and it looks like Baby Truck getting the kill onto Ender right there. Or sorry, Loop Duke, as Zero being locked up here, gets the stun. Loonshu is very low as well. He needs to get out of here. Ender picking up that kill. Ender's looking for more as well, though. He gets ignited, and he's just being kited. Ignited and kited, I should say. That blade.
Oh,
a nice play there. But a pretty nice team fight. Bad casting from the side of me and the side of Wings of Freedom.
Well, they're not really casting, but...
Well, from me.
I understand.
Oh, Loonshu running real low, but so is Hilo. So is the rest of the team of Wings of Freedom.
That was a 4-for-1.
That was a very good turnaround.
Wings of Freedom, you see, they were all blinking red.
Yeah.
They dodged everything. The Elise and Baby Chog and Hera were the targets of the Shockwave, right? They got hit by Ori's Burst. And so Elise just repelled up, and we just saw Baby Chog flash E out. So all the damage is gone. And... Well, not gone, but, like, all the low targets were gone.
Yeah.
They're out of, like, they were safe, essentially. And, Hilo just dropped a monster ulti.
Yeah.
And same thing with Baby. Once he got off, he just ripped a True Shot Barrage right down mid, and that was it.
Because, when you look at it, the dependency for RDS, they have to dive in.
You didn't say dependency.
This time I said dependency, yes.
There we go. Shout out to dependency in Tiberius.
Oh, wow. Look at this chat. This is why we have the best fans in the... Best fans in the league. In the Sassalol League.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's a full page spam.
Wow.
Yeah.
You guys are the greatest. Thanks for supporting us. Thanks for watching. Advertise this as well, because we want more than whatever viewers we got. We're greedy. But, well, I'm greedy. Let's get as much viewers as we can. Tell your friends. This is a fun time we like having here. Anyway, RDS has to dive in, get all their members relatively close. That Brandle just like depends on people to be close,
right?
Because it just bounces from champion to champion. So I guess a nice pick from Hilo, knowing they might run the same dive comp, but he has to flash out of there as Dragon's Descent just misses. But Hilo gets shut down there from Zero. Talon running really low. All four members really a lot of health on the side of RDS, but a nice flash over the wall. Getting him out of there. Herablow needs to get out of here now.
And a good hook over the wall from Ender. He actually grabs Gonjin, unfortunately, but it was still a good hook, and that's a one for nothing. One-man pickup for
Hilo
RDS.
Just, yeah, all the members there staying out of tower range, and they get that mid turret, I believe that was.
It was a 5v4, though. Baby Chug was bottom.
Yes, I did not see that. That was a nice time to fight. Exactly. Ender needs to get out of here right now, though. I don't think this tower is defendable.
No, the tier 2 mid tower is going to go down whether Wings of Freedom like it or not. Talon doesn't have his ulti. He wants to go in,
oh
but...
Oh my gosh.
He doesn't have...
Fatboy Smoothie running extremely low, but he will get out with a bit of health just... Like, the minion,
minion block, that would have hit.
Oh my gosh, Baby Truck coming in from the back. Will he be able to clean up a double kill, a triple kill, a quadra kill for Baby Truck? Give him the penta.
I don't think so.
Did he get the penta?
No, it was a robbed. It was for sure penta.
Talon, what are you doing? I think uninstall is the word I'm looking for.
He might just be.
Oh my goodness. What a play there from, oh my gosh, Baby Truck coming in from the back, changing that 5v4, and because he noticed all of them were low, the Spirit Facade, or Spirit Barrage takes out two members instantly.
True Shot Barrage. It took out two. Yeah, exactly. Two right away, and then afterwards he would just Q auto everyone because he got the red buff kite.
And Talon just greedy. There's a bit of delay there on who got the kill from like the animations, so we couldn't see exactly. That's why there was a bit of confusion from our point. But wow.
Ren took it, but I didn't want to jinx it because you never know. Penta's a Penta, right?
Yeah, exactly. But a Quadra's not a Penta, so.
Penta.
Pentas everywhere. Buffalo Bills, Item Bills, and Duck Bills being called in the chat.
A lot of bills.
a lot of bills being passed around. 13-5 in kills right here. Baby Trog 5-0-4. Got the Trinity Force. Got the BF Sword. Got the Last Whisper. Is going to be hitting extremely hard. And that those Ionian Boots, I don't really recall those too much on Ez, but
He's also picking up a Bruta.
Oh, geez, yeah, he just bought that right now, so... Wow, he's just going to be... you have any armor? It's gone.
Pretty much with Last Whisper and Bruta, yeah. He just wants to Q harass, though, I guess, with Ionian Boots. Again, maybe just a poke comp coming out of these guys with Brand, I guess? Just Ez poke all day.
Wow, that's a... That was a very nice play by Baby Truck to recognize. I thought he was going to back and just come defend that turret. But no, he I believe he got their red buff, too. He got Blue Side's red buff.
Yeah.
And then came from the back and just sniped them all off.
Pretty much, yeah. It was really, really well played from Baby to come back there and just clean up, pretty much, right?
Oh, man. Beautiful. Beautiful plays there by Wings of Freedom in general, yeah. That was a 5-for-1, because it was a 1-for-nothing, which we already called out. We thought the fight was done, but
yeah. The
fight just begins. Is Luke going to speed up? They're going to check Dragon right here. It is up, and it's going to get melted quickly here. No contestion, as that ward failed there from Luke Duke. I saw that. I did
it was
not.
Close. It was close.
You just get no vision for close, though.
So Hilo is just pushing. He's kind of pushing the top lane, because Ganjin put some pressure on the map. Hilo went up there to take it away. And then it looks like a 5-man group for mid. They have Baron buff. They want to fight. They're ahead.
Yep. This is the time to fight, too. So your strategy for fighting, if you're Wings of Freedom, your Renekton needs to go in, obviously, right away.
Yeah, they want Ren to be a wall. They can just kite backwards with Elise Cocoon.
I guess, yeah. And they have that... They're probably looking for a Blitz Hook as well, clearly.
Right.
I mean, that's what you have them for.
It's scary, though, right? Because we talked about if they hook the frontline Ganjin and Smoothie.
Yes,
it's a free ball delivery system.
As we see, it didn't let work too well last time. Or did it?
The fight was on Wings of Freedom's terms, so
yes,
that's what gave him the advantage.
As the Blitzhook does land onto Zero, but he has to flash away.
Yeah, Ender is playing really, really well in his Blitz. He roamed really early in the game.
Yeah, beautiful.
And his hooks have been really, really good for the most part.
And he's got the Talisman of Ascension.
Win in my book. Yeah.
Wow. So this is GG. Harablo Hard Carry is being called out in the chat right now because he is playing very well with the 2-1-4. We gotta look at the support as Fatboy Smoothie gets pulled in right here and they're setting the ball and the shockwave, but it does not go off. I believe no one got caught.
That's two.
Okay. I didn't think it didn't too much damage. Then looks like.
No, it got the tankies of Wings of Freedom, and then...
Yeah, wow, not doing a heck of a lot of damage there. I think Ender needs to back up just a bit, and they'll switch over the turret aggro, but yeah, the hook pull, the ball delivery system coming at the last second, I guess, and then the command shockwave, but...
There was a little miscommunication, because Ganjin, after the tower went down, he was terrified. He ulted out. He dragged Descent away, but at that point, Smoothie got hooked in, so their front line was... Yep. Way
at their back line, so...
Yeah.
No red buff.
None, unfortunately.
Unfortunately, because Baby Chog took it last time.
Baby Chog's wanting the red buff Penta again, but he cannot have.
Yeah, Ender's got to get out of there. The Mantra Q...
He's going to speed himself up?
Yeah, he should be good, even though he's only got Tier 1 boots. Yeah,
Blitz is so fast to begin with, too. The W is just, like, 400 million move speed, I think, is what he gets.
Yeah, roughly.
Yeah.
It's around, give or take one or two.
Million, so either way, like 399 plus.
Absolutely.
This game is going to be so hard for RDS to come back from.
It will be. Not impossible by no means, but yes, very, very tough for them.
Because their team fight's so good, right? They have a really good team fight team, but they haven't really executed this game as well as they did last game.
Exactly. They haven't turned a 5v4 into a... What was that last game? That big team fight?
It was initially RDS... lost one, and they were scared of Wings. They were four against the five team Wings, and then they full aced.
That was a wicked play. Definitely, but a lot of big kills coming in from this game and last game. We got almost a Penta, except for Talon had to be really greedy there from Baby Trog. And then we had like a quadra kill last game, and then followed by a triple on the side of Loonshu. But the CS by them is actually quite well. Loonshu has the highest CS next to Hilo in the mid there. 80 CS behind. Zero's 80 CS behind.
Hilo.
Yeah, Hilo right there. Sorry, just trying to get names all figured out. As the sweeper trinket. Wings of Freedom need more sweeper trinkets, in my opinion. Your jungler should get one, and possibly your mid laner. When you have this much control over the game right now, I think it's... You want the sweepers. I think that's just straight up. The hook of this is onto Qui-Gon Jinn. I don't think you really want to hook Qui-Gon Jinn in anyway.
Not at this point. I mean, Ori was mid at the time, so it's kind of safe, but Loon's still there, right? It's a 3v2.
Yes.
You don't want to necessarily fight that.
Definitely not.
So we just see Wings of Freedom, 5-manning bottom. They have the turret, and they inhib down to mid lane. So Super Minion's just going to pour into the base. That's why they're pushing the side lane. And RDS is going to have to send someone mid to stop the push.
I don't know if they can defend this tower too well. I said that last time, and then Baby Trog got a Penta on the other side.
Baby Trog is chunked to half, though.
Yeah, well, he's lifesteal.
Yeah, he's going to lifesteal off the wave, and the team's just going to say, hey, no problem. We don't need it.
Yeah.
And yeah, Gon Jinn is just sent to mid lane to defend against the supers, but...
They see this. They could go in with this minion wave here, or they might just try to take the turret really quickly, because yeah, Qui-Gon Jinn not there. They only have one tank. I think it might be... a pillar doing a lot of damage, and in comes Qui-Gon Jinn from the side. But this poke from Brand and from Baby Trog. Hilo and Baby Trog doing a lot of damage here.
Oh yeah, and... Baron's going to be up in 6 seconds. That could be the next objective as well. It'll help their poke too, because they can just regen the health that they take back, or the damage that they take back.
A hook, onto Qui-Gon Jinn, mid lane. Oh, Dragon's Descent as he's knocked up. I love seeing that animation, because the game wasn't like made for that. It kind of screws it up, but a nice escape there. But he's running really low. He needs to back. He's got those... He does not have those home guards, so he will not be able to heal up right away.
Everyone just trade tower shots at this point. They're
Everyone
going in
take
one
tower shot.
Yeah.
And then go back.
Yeah.
Baby Trog just gonna get back to reality. Oh, there goes gravity.
Pretty much, yeah. Talon's just gonna be the big front line now. He just wants to walk up, take some tower shots if he has to. I mean, everyone's doing it.
Yeah, might as well take your turn, everyone. As Baby Trog taking a few as there. Get the turret. And the inhib in the mid should be up pretty soon. But they're looking for inhibitor turrets. I think get this inhib right here. Yeah, they are. Sorry.
They're going to get the inhib. It's a free inhib. Gon Jinn wants to fight, though.
And the command shockwave hitting two or three members there. Qui-Gon Jinn at the back lines there. Trying to focus down Baby Trog. Going for Herablo right now. And it looks like Fatboy Smoothie running real low. And Herablo being taken down, as well as Qui-Gon Jinn. That's both tanks gone for the side of RDS, and they need to push. They can end it right here. But a nice flash from Loonshu actually getting away. Ender running really low. They might not be able to fight it right now. A tether goes on to Baby Trog, but a nice arcane shift away, and they're all really low. But Hilo doing some work in the mid lane, trying to get that inhib.
That was absolutely crazy. What happened was Zero shockwaved Hera and Talon, the tankiest members of Wings of Freedom at this point, right?
Uh-oh.
Hilo might be caught.
No, he is! I'm not sure if he was just too focused on Luke Duke or didn't think the other members were right
Hilo
there.
Hilo just too greedy for the inhib and ends in paying his life.
Looks like you have Talon and Hilo, the greedy ones on this team.
So this is really, really huge because that's Wings of Freedom's wave clear, right?
Yeah.
They don't really have a lot without Brand. I mean, Ren's not going to do much. Ez can do his True Shot Barrage, sure, but then that's, it's one wave.
Exactly. So, and Baron is up. Are they going for it? Right now
they're rushing
are.
Because they know Hera was
Gosh, and the Wings of Freedom aren't really far right now, but they're taking down this Baron really slow, but with Fatboy Smoothie there, hopefully it can do a bit of work as Elise is going to come check this out.
Elise is great to steal. Like we said, she can smite and then just cue it in spider form, and that should be enough to grab it.
Oh my gosh, this could be a game changer right here. It's running extremely low.
And she didn't even attempt to go in.
Yeah, that's kind of odd.
Smoothie smited early as well, so there was a
chance.
Oh,
man. Smite from Fatboy Smoothie. Good at that, but...
Yeah, the call from Wings of Freedom was just to not go in. Don't risk your life for the Baron. It's fine. We can just group and fight. 5-5, or wait out the Baron, because we have an inhib down bottom, right?
And 12,000 gold lead, plus whatever this dragon gives. Not 13,000 gold lead, right here. So, yeah, they're doing... I think they're just fine, but yeah, that Baron buff's just going to be used mainly to defend, obviously. They can't really push out with two inhibs down, or one inhib down, sorry. Hilo did not get that second one.
Well, exactly, and then the Baron buff is... It's just kind of a deterrence for Wings of Freedom to fight them, right? Because the Baron is... It's a huge buff for a team. Especially if you're behind, it's a good swinging game pace.
They might just be looking to farm their own jungle, farm the enemy team's jungle, farm anything they can. Until they get their last items here, it looks like Brand might be going for that DFG.
That's a favorite item I see on Hilo. He always grabs it on TF as well.
Oh yeah?
Yeah. Which I find odd, but again, I'm not a mid player. I don't really play TF, even when I do joke around in the mid lane, but... Yeah, I find it an interesting build.
I mean, the more damage, the better, I guess, always. So, but the wave clear actually from Sivir doing a lot of work there with that whole Luke Duke being taken down quite hard. But that shield.
The shields are
very
so strong.
Very strong, yeah. Ender right, going right to the back line. On the Hunt is popped from the AD carry from Sivir right there. Command Shockwave hitting two members, and it looks like Hilo goes down right away. This could be time for RDS to fight back, as it looks like the Blitzcrank gets a kill onto Fatboy Smoothie. Qui-Gon Jinn going to be stunned up here, and Baby Truck gets that kill. And they're going to keep looking for more. Ender running extremely low, but in comes Talon to peel them off. Lingxiu getting stunned up. Karablu needs to back up. Baby Drog as well. I think he's getting a bit cocky here. Yeah, Lingxiu's still full health, though. I mean, that's pretty incredible.
1-for-2 thus far.
Yeah, all four members, though, on Wings of Freedom are pretty low.
Aside from Talon, Talon needs to be the front line for Baby right now. He needs to.
He can't take much poke. As the hook coming in from Lingxiu, is this a good idea? Oh, it just gets melted. But the barrier and the shield from Karma coming in. Lingxiu running extremely low. Talon gets it with the team at right there. Or the Hydro right there. As Talon getting a double kill. But not before Lingxiu picks up a kill onto Ender. And Herablo needs to back. Baby Truck going to get that inhibitor. And the bottom inhibitor just respawned as well.
The bait was so juicy. Lingxiu wanted all four kills. Because you saw, they were all so low,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, definitely.
And then Blitz just corner played him perfectly, and then they all focus fired Loon, and that was huge, huge win because they took the Baron off him.
That's true. Did all five members go down or no?
Zero still has Baron.
Yes.
Zero didn't die. He was so close to dying, but then when Loon got hooked, he was in base healing.
Oh, okay.
So he wasn't there for the fight.
So yeah, good job by Wings of Freedom to say, hey, they got Baron buff, but we're just stronger. And go in on that. I love Brand's footsteps there. That's a wicked skin, like, detail.
I believe it's like an ultimate, or when it
like,
was.
When it, like, because, yeah, they just released it for this Harrowing or whatever, the Harrowing. But, yeah, I guess they re-released it kind of thing?
Yeah. When it first came out, and then they re-released it for
this year's
the
Halloween.
Legacy skins, or
yeah,
whatever.
Yeah.
All of them came back, yeah. Well, not all of them, most. Maybe all.
A lot.
Probably.
A lot.
Probably not
I know
all.
There was one skin, it wasn't Blitzcrank's skin, but... It was it's probably my favorite skin. Can't tell you who it was, but...
Definitely not?
It wasn't Blitzcrank, I know.
Oh,
my favorite skin in the game.
Do you have that one?
No, I don't, unfortunately.
It came back! How do you know?
I don't even have... I have 17 champions.
Oh, my.
I haven't played for very long.
How does this happen?
Oh, my gosh.
Calls out his favorite skin. It came back. Doesn't even get it. Oh, man.
Hey, man. University student on a budget, that's for sure. Unlike Predinchuk, who actually dropped university, like I said before, to play in the Sasquatch League. I'm going to bring that up again.
Right.
It's a beautiful fact.
Yeah. This is crazy. They're just going to try to get the double inhibs down for Wings of Freedom. They just want minions pouring in. They're just going to do the same thing top lane.
They're kind of having a tough time finishing out this game.
They're scared of the team fight from RDS, right?
I think so, yeah. Just how it turned last game, so...
And... It's just the respect level from it, because they said, hey, like, they're tanky, we don't want to get...
Qui-Gon Jinn getting silenced, not being able to use that Dragon's Descent right away. And now they're running away! Looks like Talon's running really low. Hilo picking up a kill onto Zero right here, and is ult taking everyone low on the side of RDS, but a lot of people are low on... Wings of Freedom right here. The jungler running real low, at least running real low. The hook just misses Lingxiu, who flashes away. And this could be a free inhib, because all the members are extremely low.
Wings of Freedom kited back... Perfectly.
Yeah, I thought they were just running for their lives, but...
Hilo just waited for everyone to just run at them, which they did. That's what we talked about, how that's their only initiation on this team comp, just to run directly at them.
Yes.
And Blitz helps by pulling them in. But when they all ran at him, Hilo dropped his ulti, and it ricocheted twice on Luke, for sure. And then they just bursted down zero, and after that, you don't really have much AoE.
Yeah, definitely. That was, Hilo so strong in these team fights, with his ult on Brand. And it looks like we'll be able to pick up a DFG pretty, if not right now, or not.
Possibly.
He's out of shop right now.
He's got his Athene's Codex. 2,000.
2,000, so I think it's like 2,200. He might just be looking to farm a bit and Baron up in a minute. Still plenty of time. Has Herablo actually taken that red? I think that's better on Baby Trog, but hey.
Buff taken.
Yeah, buff taken's a buff taken, that's for sure.
Yeah. I don't think RDS can contest this Baron. They shouldn't. No. They have two inhibs down. I mean, Zero's going to try his best to protect the base in the meantime, but Wings of Freedom don't even need the Baron at this point, right?
Oh, a flash being used out from Luke right there. Has that top turret. That's good. Good for them to get that, the Arcane, or the Barrage.
True Shot.
True Shot Barrage. Keep getting that one wrong. Is actually sent upwards to get those minions at the top there.
Yeah, they just want to push lane. They realize they don't necessarily need the
Baron. Oh, and the Dragon's Ascent coming in. And it looks like the ult from Maokai has popped, and this is going to hurt Wings of Freedom right here. Herablo taking extremely low. A knock-up onto Qui-Gon Jinn, but it gets out of there and gets healed by quite a bit.
Nishu wasn't even there that fight.
They could have probably initiated, but it was RDS, yeah, who initiated.
Lunshu was all the way in bot lane protecting the base, and then they just initiated three men without Zero even.
So that's going to result in a little inhibitor right here, and bot one's still down.
That was just a very impatient play by RDS.
They
wanted to just teamfight them right away before the minions just kept pouring in the base, because Wings of Freedom, they know what they're doing, they wanted to push topside. Minions are just going to flood RDS's base at this point, so RDS just had to make a move, and unfortunately they did it without their carries.
And all five are going to the Dragon and not the Baron, which is live. I think they could have sent a few to the Baron, but it looks like Hilo will be backing, hopefully, to get that DFG right now. Has the most CS. No, Lunchu actually taking the CS lead with that static shiv, helping out a ton. And this is entering the late game. 45-minute game so far. 21-9 in kills for the side of Wings of Freedom.
There is a 16k gold difference from these two teams in favor of Wings of Freedom. But as the game goes on and builds progress, the gold difference doesn't really mean that much.
Exactly. So I think Wings of Freedom need to get this Baron, end the game. Like, straight up. That's just something they need to do, as the DFG is picked up from Hilo. So that he can pick a target, ult, and that target will die instantly. So as it looks like this, they might try to contest it. I think they just... Oh boy, it looks like we might have a team fight here. That's Ender knocking up Fatboy Smoothie right there, who's going to go in, and I believe the Command Shockwave was used. I'm not sure it hit too many people. The Repel coming in from Herablo, who gets low. No, it's still, sorry, gets down and is attacking a lot of people. Fatboy Smoothie coming in. The Cocoon, I'm doing terrible right now. Talon, actually, that Dominance saving his life right there. That's a triple kill for the side of Baby Trog right there. And that's an ace for the side of Wings of Freedom. They might just look to end, and that's the smart thing to do.
Yeah, they have supers right at the base. They already took one base tower. That's all that they had to do, was just keep them at Baron. They have two inhibitors down. The supers are just going to flood the base.
And it looks like that will be game. And we had Elray actually call it one for one this series. That'll be Wings of Freedom taking over RDS in Game 2.
In the Sask Law League, Week 4, Day 2.
Absolutely.
Crazy, crazy game. Wings of Freedom learned what went wrong in Game 1, and it's pretty much the exact same team comp, just Jinx was banned out.
Exactly, yep.
And, yeah, Wings of Freedom just able to take Game 2.
Yeah, RDS, you know, if it's not broken, don't fix it.
If it's broken, you fix it.
If it is, but it wasn't broken, so they didn't fix it.
But now it's broken.
But now it's broken. So they'll have to think of something different. Wings of Freedom, nice job reacting to that and figuring out a way to win. Congratulations. 11-0-8 on Baby Trog, I'd like to point out. That's incredible with that almost penta.
It was pretty much a penta.
6-0-18, sorry, on Talon as well. I mean,
Talon definitely stepped up his game.
Yeah, they came to play today.
He played a lot safer in top lane, and then they had a whole lot of help too.
Yeah, especially with Ender roaming.
Yeah, that ball lane synergy, right? Talon and Ender.
Yep. No. Yeah. I guess. Yeah. It was kind of like AD carry Talon right there. Back to its ways.
Yeah. The game two went really, really well for Wings of Freedom.
Absolutely. And I'm not sure where these guys land in the standings right now. I think RDS is still ahead.
They won't. Yeah, RDS and yes. Wings won't change because I believe RDS is 3 and Wings is seeded at 4 right now.
Okay, so yes, this is the 3rd and 4th place teams. The Muffin Stuffers in 2nd and Just Us Guys undefeated, 14-0 in 1st place.
They're doing really, really well.
They are.
They're the team to beat.
Yeah, they have nothing to do except lose. Like, that's all they're, like, playing for, except for, obviously, the championship. This is so wrong. But you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know. The only thing they can do, really. No, I don't know what I'm trying to say, but you know what I'm trying to say? You said it earlier. You said it earlier. We'll just go with, yeah.
Just remind the VOD and watch it over again. I'm sure.
I'm going to.
We'll never know what I said. Yeah, I say a lot of things on stream.
But thanks for watching, everyone. I know it's a Wednesday night. Remember, this is streamed every Sunday and Wednesday night at 9 p.m. Central Standard Time. Keep watching, because this is a lot of fun. And March 23rd is the finals. Anything else I'm forgetting?
Not necessarily. You pretty much covered all the bases. However, my co-caster here, Wallachian, will not be here for Sunday. Hank One will be back. Let us know, by the way, how you like the cast with myself and Wallachian. If it was better or worse. I mean, Hank would love to know that it was worse, but yeah. Let's be fair, okay? The Wallachian is God.
No, we call him Land God for a reason.
He does not exist. But, yeah, thanks for tuning in. Again, we'll be back Sunday night at 9.
And check out our YouTube channel, because it's got some other games that are not live-streamed, but are recorded.
And you can find the link for that on the Sask Law League page.
SaskLawLeague.blogspot.ca.
That's the one. Alright, until Sunday night at 9, we are out of here.
Bye-bye.